defensive MVP of two Aggies Bowl victories. Today, he leads Texas A&M into its season opener against the LSU Tigers. Southwest Conference Football. And it's brought to you by Southwest Airlines, celebrating 20 years of providing everyday low fares and convenient flights to many exciting destinations. Also brought to you in part by NCNB. By Budweiser. By Dr. Pepper. By Exxon Phase 4 Gasoline. And by Buick. We welcome you to Aggie Land for the kickoff game for season number 8 of Southwest Conference Football here on Raycom. Today, the number 20 Aggies play host to their SEC rivals from LSU. Welcome to Kyle Field and College Station. Dave Barnett, along with former NFL All-Pro defensive lineman Dave Rowe. A 9-3-1 Texas A&M team, missing an awful lot of familiar talent from last year. But in year 3 of R.C. Slocum's program, are they rebuilding or are they reloading?
Well, Dave, you would think that they were going to be rebuilding with the loss of talent that they had. However, when you look at two outstanding recruiting classes, and then you look at the blue-chip backup players like Sam Adams and Rodney Thomas, I think they're reloading.
One position that Slocum is glad he does not have to replace this year is quarterback. He says he'll build any team around Bucky Richardson.
Oh, boy. When I look at Bucky Richardson, I see two things. I see confidence, leadership, and another thing that jumps out is 6.9 yards per carry.
Nice storyline, we thought, for LSU. It's a homecoming for their head coach, Curly Hallman. However, as of 2 days ago, wholesale changes for the Tigers. He has replaced literally half his starters from their opener last week, a 31-10 loss at Georgia, including all-SEC receiver Todd Kinchin, all-SEC defensive end Mark Boutte, and starting quarterback Chad Loops. So early in the year, what effect do wholesale changes have?
Well, obviously they can have two effects. They can have the positive effect or the negative effect. I think what Curly Hallman is doing is making a statement saying, I want intensity. I didn't get it last week. I want dedication in practice. I didn't get it. So he's made changes. But I just don't see how you can bench two all-SEC players and expect to win a football game.
LSU, a decided underdog today. However, they've dominated this series since it resumed back in 1986. In fact, the only Aggie win since then, right here, 2 years ago. We return for the kickoff after this from Southwest Airlines.
Ever since Southwest Airlines introduced our Friends Fly Free sale, people have gotten friendlier.
Sugar Plum, your favorite pillow.
If you make reservations and buy your round-trip ticket at our regular low unrestricted fare by October 31st, a friend gets to fly with you this fall, free.
Hey, Dad, seen the hedge trimmer?
You and a friend can travel through January 6th.
Here's that putter I borrowed last year, old buddy.
Southwest Airlines Friends Fly Free sale. It's great for your pocketbook and your popularity.
Reintroducing a glorious name for a glorious new automobile, the 1992 Buick Roadmaster. With its powerful V8 performance and the security of its driver's airbag, anti-lock brakes, and full perimeter frame, Roadmaster is perhaps the best value in an American luxury sedan. Roadmaster also delivers something only a Buick can deliver, Buick quality.
Felix Popo.
Upon graduation from Escoffier, some of these culinary masters go to London or Rome.
André Legault.
Others go to sea and work their magic on Norwegian Cruise Line. No cruise line caters to food the way we do. Norwegian Cruise Line. The best vacation you've ever had. To say nothing of the chocolate cake, a la André Legault.
Warm and windy at Kyle Field and College Station. A capacity of 70,000. They expect to approach that today. 65,000 and upwards. LSU, one of the all-time great interconference rivals for the Aggies. And time today to check our Southwest Airlines team musts for LSU.
Well, first of all, Dave, they have to get off to a quick start. They've got to gain some confidence. Last week, they didn't move the ball. Their confidence went right downhill. They had no offensive continuity last week. Couldn't run, couldn't pass. Neither one set each other up. And, of course, Loop started last week. Daigle this week. They need to pick a quarterback and go with them.
All right, how about for R.C. Slocum and Texas A&M?
Well, for Texas A&M, they are the quickest starting team in the nation last year. Outscored their opponents 245 to 107 in the first half, and they need to continue that. They're a very young team. They're going to make mistakes. They only have seven returning starters. And GHT is Greg Hill time. If you don't know his name now, you'll know it after this game.
Those are our Southwest Airlines team musts. And the Aggies set to return the kick. R.C. Slocum's third year as the head man here in College Station. One of the subplots, as you look at the deep backs for the Aggies, Greg Hill and Wilbert Biggins, actually now Rodney Thomas, a late addition as a deep back, is a kicker. LSU sent home their kicker last night, Pedro Suarez. He violated unspecified disciplinary rules, and so this is a true freshman. Matt Huerkamp with an awfully strong leg in high school at Shalimar, Florida. 80% of his kickoffs went through the end zone. And with a strong southerly breeze behind him, he booms this one a good 6 yards deep. And Biggins, with his first collegiate effort, has a big return out across the 30-yard line.
I was just about to say, you don't return the ball 6 yards deep in the end zone, but when you bring it out to the 30, that's where the coach says, oh no, way to
great
go.
Great play. And Bucky Richardson, the senior from Baton Rouge. A&M won a heated recruiting war with LSU to gain his services. This time a year ago, the backup to Lance Pavlis. Midseason, it became Bucky's team. They grounded out. They became an eye-oriented option attack again. And Greg Hill time begins on first down. Off left tackle, 3 yards for the redshirt freshman from Dallas Carter. Our NCNB starting offensive lineup for Texas A&M, along with Richardson to the backfield. Hill, the man you're going to hear an awful lot about, and Doug Carter, the fullback. Greg Shorp is the tight end. Tony Harrison and Brian Mitchell are the young wideouts. And up front, Wesley Harrison, Dawson Ellisor, the only returning starter, and Alex. And a flag down prior to the snap on second down. Doyle Jackson is our referee today.
I think we saw some movement there on Dexter Wesley, left tackle for A&M.
Well, what would have been second and 7 turns into second and 12.
Dead ball. Ball starts. Offense. Still a second down.
The LSU defense, as we said, a lot of new faces. We're not sure how long they're going to stay in, but people like Brian Madden, late additions on the defensive line. King, Deschatel, a true freshman, Williams, Adams, Young, and Marshall. We expect to see some of the regulars by maybe the second A&M series. A lot of room for Bucky. And a scrambling first down. Corey White chased him out from outside linebacker. First down, Aggie.
Boy, and that is such a pressure for the defense to answer. When that quarterback can stand back there and just look downfield, has all the time to pass it, no pressure. Now, just put that ball down. And when you have the running abilities of a Bucky Richardson, you pick up that first down.
Of course, he's a linebacker playing quarterback, really. He's 221 pounds. He's heavier than a lot of the guys who are going to try and tackle him. And 4-5 speed. Ryan Mitchell in motion. Up the middle for a couple. Doug Carter replacing Wilson at fullback. Those are some heavy shoes because Robert Wilson went straight to the pros after his junior year.
You have to be able to block in this A&M scheme, though. You have got to be able to get in there, get that linebacker, and drive him off the line. So Carter's going, you're right, he has some big shoes to fill.
He's a junior from Thomas Jefferson in Dallas. He is Michael Carter's brother. Michael, of course, the longtime nose tackle for the San Francisco 49ers. Greg Hill time again. He's near the first down marker in LSU territory. They list him at 5'11", 190. He admits to being 208. He has done some pumping up during the offseason. He runs a 4.440, and he didn't lose any speed, adding 18 pounds.
Well, he's the kind of runner, when he gets the ball, he looks for the hole. When he sees that hole, he just slashes through it.
Aggies bring him up in the eye. They still need one on third down. And the fullback with the flag down. Carter inside the 30 if it stands. 18-yard pickup before Corey Raymond, the right corner, brought down Carter. Now we'll see about the indication. It will stand.
That's lining up in the neutral zone.
Offsides, defense declined, first down.
I'll tell you, Keith Alex got a great block. He's number 67. We may see him, and well, he was really wasn't in that picture, but he got a great block on his tackle. There he is, 67. Watch him drive off and pin him down inside. Now watch the hole. Right through the hole there. Oh, boy. That's a two-plus block.
That right side of the offensive line, a key for A&M. They've got Ellisor, the returning starter at guard, but they need Alex to be a cornerstone right next to him at tackle. And the Aggies call time. 12 minutes and 38 seconds in the first quarter. A&M taking the opening kickoff and driving steadily on the ground. Nothing, nothing early on at Kyle Field in College Station.
When it comes to a game, can't stay away. Ain't sitting home, not if they're gonna play. Spring or fall, every year. All right, nothing beats a Bud right here. Yeah, nothing beats our best Budweiser. Nothing beats a Bud. Where you hear the cheers, you'll find the king of beers. Yeah, nothing beats a Bud.
There is a new gasoline that is clearly advanced. A new gasoline that will give you the highest level of engine cleaning for high performance. A new gasoline formulated to clean fuel injectors and intake valves. Who has this new gasoline? You know who. New Phase 4 gasoline from Exxon. For cleaner engines and high performance.
Buying a new car involves some difficult decisions.
Okay, let's see. Four-door? Not two-door.
Hey, maybe no doors. At NCNB, we don't think financing should be one of them.
Well, you gotta be kidding.
That's why we've set up a loan information line. Call with your questions or stop by and see a loan specialist.
Way too fast.
Then move on to the really difficult decisions.
Okay, red. No, blue. Maybe white.
1-800-ASK-NCNB.
Two-tone?
The loan source.
Glad to be at Kyle Field. We also welcome all of our viewers along the Prime Network. They'll be with us throughout 1991. Every week, our Southwest Conference Game of the Week. After the timeout, 12:38 to go in a scoreless first quarter and a steady Aggie drive as they look at first down and 10. Option keeper for Richardson. That's that 220 pounds of pure muscle. Turns it up for an extra couple of yards.
You see when he puts his head down, how he just doesn't fall down? He has that leg drive. Words like gazelle will never be used to describe Bucky Richardson. It's more like bull.
Did you see any two-plus blocks on that play? And what is a two-plus block?
Well, that's the way they grade offensive linemen. You get a zero if you perform your actual duty. Then you get a one if you block your man. You get a two if you nail him, like Keith Alex did on that last play.
Still on the ground. Hill, a lot of room and a first down. 17-yard line. Greg Hill time, wasting no time unfolding here in the first quarter. And our first check of the Dr. Pepper scoreboard. Number 17, Georgia Tech rolling, as is number 19, Ohio State. The people we talked to here yesterday said that even in the Darren Lewis freshman year, there was nowhere approaching the amount of buzz, the anticipation that approached Greg Hill's debut today.
Absolutely. I mean, there has been just It's been a media blitz here. And Greg Hill said, I'm not going to be satisfied unless I get 100 yards.
He wanted to clean up a quote. He was quoted in the battalion, the student newspaper, saying, I will win the Heisman before I leave. He said, would you change that? I said, I want to win the Heisman. Big difference. And a delay penalty on A&M. A couple of times they have come to the line and not been exactly sure of what they wanted. It cost them a timeout, and here it cost them 5 yards.
When if you're a head coach, you do not want to lose 5 yards down in what we call the four down area. Anytime you get inside the 30-yard line, that's called four downs because you can go on it on fourth down. R.C. Slocum doesn't want to give up a free 5 yards to the defense on a penalty like that.
Harrison right, Mitchell left on first and 15. One and counting for GHT. 6-0 Texas A&M. Terry Venetulius, the new placement man, kickoff specialist last year. And he is good, and so is this guy.
Well, first of all, at the point of attack where the ball is supposed to go through the line, they get a great surge right there. Now he runs through clean. Now what a setup move right there. Get outside, keeps that balance. He has got all the tools that they said he had. There he goes again. Now watch again. Nice little move right there. But look at the size of the hole in the line. Set up the backer. Get outside. And it's just a jog into the end zone.
Wholesale changes up front for Texas A&M. But no difference in terms of production on their first 1991 drive. And we return after this message from Southwest Airlines.
I grew up in Texas.
On this, our 20th anniversary, Southwest Airlines proudly unfurls Lone Star One, a high-flying tribute to the indomitable spirit that makes Texas a true state of mind.
Shining in the Texas sky, the Lone Star is flying high.
What's in is out, what's out is in. If you don't know where on earth have you been?
Yeah.
Don't try to sell me, I know what tastes good.
We know
while
it.
The best thing's always so misunderstood. Just give me what the doctor ordered.
Dr.
Just what the doctor ordered.
Driving after a few drinks is crazy. Don't wreck your life.
Well, isn't this where the Aggies left off last year? They scored 65 against BYU in the Holiday Bowl. They take the opening kick of 91 and punch it right through the middle of the LSU defense. On a 70-yard drive, 38 of the 70 go to Greg Hill, and it's 7-0. Venetulius into the wind, and this is extremely short. From the 17-yard line. And a return up to the 29 for Gary Pegues. At A&M scoring drive, covering 8 plays in only 3 minutes and 45 seconds. Hill gets the credit, but right behind him has got to be that new offensive line because he had so many huge holes to pick and choose his way through.
Absolutely. When your offensive line opens up holes like that, they're so wide that you don't even have to make a move into the hole. You know they're controlling the line of scrimmage.
Well, last week it was Chad Luke. This week it's Jesse Daigle. Sophomore from Baton Rouge at quarterback. Marcus Carter, the flanker, goes in motion and out of the eye. It's Odell Beckham out of Marshall, Texas, and he slams off tackle for five. The LSU offense will line up this way. Beckham and Seamster, another man elevated this week in the backfield. Bishop back at tight end from last week, and Jacob and Carter with Kinchin expected to see some action off the bench. He single-handedly beat A&M last year. Mawai leads the up front men, and a lot of changes there as well. That's our NCNB starting offensive lineup for LSU. Beckham got five, second and five. Seamster might have lost one. Eric England from right defensive end. And along with England up front, Lance Tackleman and Pat Henry back after some injury-plagued years. The elbow is about 80-90% for Henry. The linebacking crew, always outstanding here in College Station. Buckley and Coriot lead the way this year. Kevin Smith, already the co-holder of the SWC career interception record, leads the secondary. Third and six, Daigle to the air, broken up, almost picked off by Ramsey Bradbury, the nickelback. You couldn't ask for a better start by the Aggies.
No, you couldn't. You come out there, you hold them, you get the ball, you're going to get good field position. Excellent reaction there by Bradbury, number eight, to the ball. Once the ball's up in the air, you have to react to it. He almost comes up with the interception.
Let's give credit to Chris Crooms, the strong safety who made the deflection, and Brian Griffith punted for an average of 40 yards at Georgia last week. He has the win behind him. Biggins, who returned the opening kick from 5 yards deep, stands at his 18. Heavy rush, low spiral. And Biggins wisely to his knees at the 18-yard line. 49 yards with that win behind him for Griffith. At the conclusion of today's game, Dave and I will announce the Southwest Airlines player of the game, so please stay with us and keep that in mind. 65,000 or so at Kyle Field today, 7-0, Texas A&M.
And this is the same type of start that LSU got last week. Came out, didn't drive the ball, couldn't hold the other team. That's what A&M wants to continue, that same thing. Let them lose their confidence, have a nice long drive in here, and take control of this football game.
Nothing fancy on that first series. Richardson hardly had to think about an air attack, and he keeps it on the ground again to Hill. Cut back to the 33. Darren who? Maybe not yet. Now, Darren Lewis, as R.C. Slocum says, with 5,000 career yards, Greg Hill, when he gets to 5,000, will then be mentioned in the same breath as Darren Lewis. But what a start.
I thought that was a great comment. He said, compare him to Darren Lewis? Where did he get 5,000 yards? But boy, he's making a mark today. Look at that. Five rushes, over 10 yards a carry.
Cliff Gross, true freshman from College Station, in as an extra back. Richardson keeps to the 38-yard line. Sean King, outside linebacker, a sophomore from Monroe, Louisiana, making the stop. Bucky says, obviously, this is a big game. Anytime you play your hometown team, a school that you almost signed with, but it's especially big today because it's his father's birthday, and he would love to present a victory over LSU to his father as a present today. He got four, second and six. Quick toss, Harrison. The first down. Looked over, saw the marker, tiptoed his way there. And Harrison, the only scholarship wide receiver who had a catch in his career, grabs one here, and Richardson comes up limping.
Looks as if it's in the ankle area. He's limping on that right leg. Boy, they can't afford to lose him.
Boy, is that an understatement. And Kent Petty, junior from Dallas Lake Highlands, into the game for A&M. It didn't look all that serious. It's easy for us to say from up here, but it looked like the type thing, if they retape it, he might be right back in. A lot of room up the middle. Doug Carter, the fullback, to the LSU 30.
Dave, we've mentioned a lot about Greg Hill's ability to cut back, but Carter made an excellent cut that time. It was a weak side play going to his left, and he made a tremendous adjustment around the center. Watch the play. It's going to go to his left. Takes it right there, plants, and cuts back right in here around the center's block right there. And makes a nice move getting up yardage, getting up field.
Marshall and McCorvey, the safeties, dragged him down after 26 yards. And another flag on, I believe, delay of game. Not sure if the Aggies got it off before the play clock expired. They are retaping Bucking.
Well, you think there doesn't fall a hush over top of this crowd? Everybody saw him leave the field limping. They see a new quarterback go in, and everybody's gazing down exactly where we are.
He didn't even want to think about any more missed time because he basically missed half his career coming off a knee injury suffered early in his career against Texas. The Aggies biting off huge chunks on first down. They need 15 here. On the draw, Carter dragged down by Reggie Walker, senior linebacker from New Orleans and an all-academic SEC man. And now Carter slow getting up.
Hey, if Reggie Walker doesn't make that tackle, Carter's going for a big chunk. It was a misdirection play. They feel LSU is guessing a little bit on defense, obviously, and they ran a misdirection play. Action starts one way, the draw comes back against the line and tries to find that hole, that seam to the weak side.
Well, again, it looked like an ankle problem, as was the case with Richardson. This, obviously, much more severe.
Well, I asked R.C. Slocum what his main concern was in this football game, and it was interesting. He said LSU has had one game more than us. They got to practice, or play, I should say, at full speed. Regardless of how much you practice, you never practice at full speed. So that's his big concern today.
LSU's big concern is that A&M got to look at the game film from the Georgia game.
Yeah, they were a little upset about that.
All they had to do was tape the game. It was regionally televised. 131-2 in total yards. They've averaged 10 on first down. It's second and 12. Greg Hill to the 25. That'll leave him about 5 yards short, and that's one of his shorter gains here in the first quarter.
I was just thinking he only made 5 or 6 yards on that carry.
He'll be disappointed. One of the reasons that there's such a buzz around Hill is that he was not all that highly touted coming out of high school. The reason is he didn't transfer to Dallas Carter until the year after they won state in 1988. He was at Bishop Dunn in Dallas that year. He transferred the next year. They couldn't go to the playoffs because of a probation. And he was somewhat highly recruited, but Slocum said if he had been at Carter all along, everybody in the country would know about Greg Hill. Aggies had burned their second timeout. And we're barely halfway done in the first quarter. 7:04 remaining, 7-0, Texas A&M.
Why Farm Bureau Insurance?
Their rates are competitive and help me get great coverage for my money.
When you have a claim, Farm Bureau service is fair and fast.
Our agent put together a plan to help save for their future.
Helping you is what we do best. That's why people across America, from every walk of life, depend on Farm Bureau Insurance.
Americans like you.
And you don't even have to be a farmer, just smart.
At Exxon, we think of engines as precise works of art, moving sculptures that come to life with stunning grace. We believe every engine deserves an enduring, powerful life. We believe every engine deserves a motor oil that offers uncompromising protection for a flawless performance. Exxon Superflow Motor Oil. For uncompromising protection against engine wear.
7-0 Texas A&M However, early on, with just over 7 minutes to go in the first quarter, they've already got two starters on the bench being retaped.
Well, that has to be a big concern. They are controlling the ball on the ground. They're controlling this game, but the loss of two starters, wouch.
And as we said at the outset, the one guy that Slocum is glad he didn't have to replace is his quarterback, and all of a sudden, Bucky Richardson, in terms of his return, is still up in the air. He's been out for this entire series. Kent Petty remains the man in control, and Doug Carter also being retaped on the sidelines. So the true freshman, Cliff Gross, is the fullback, and Carter is nailed in the backfield this time. William Crowell, true freshman, nose tackle with the stop.
And Crowell just guesses right, just comes right around the center, and bam, there he is. That's the first time they've stopped A&M in the backfield all day. They have not stopped them for negative yardage in the game so far.
Word from the Aggie sideline is it's the foot that was sprained for Bucky. It's the ankle for Carter. Both probably will be back. And they go for it on 4th and 7. Petty chased by Boutte, lets it fly way over the head of the intended receiver, Brian Mitchell, at LSU holds.
Now the difference on that play, if that had been Bucky Richardson, he'd have brought that ball down and run. Once he got around the outside containment, he'd have taken off downfield.
That's a team that needed something good to happen. They needed that defense to stiffen. Now they need Daigle to get something going on offense. They had very little offense last week. They didn't have a first down at Georgia, in fact, until midway into the second period. By that time, Daigle had come off the bench and replaced Chad Luke. Did a good job jump-starting them. He bogged down in the second half. Delivery incomplete. Crooms, a big hitter at strong safety against the tight end, Harold Bishop.
Well, they call him the Wrecking Crew, and they call him Desert Storm, too. And they really are a storm back in that secondary. They've just got excellent one-on-one and area coverage people. They just can play either way. They can play zone. They can play man-to-man. They can run with anyone.
Daigle is opposed to Luke, much more of a spread-out type passer. He is only 5'11". He's not big enough to drop back, as is Luke at 6'2". Look for more patterns just like that last one. This is Beckham. And again, the Aggie defense closes in a hurry. Quentin Coriat from inside linebacker with the first contact. He is probably the next great Aggie linebacker if he's not already.
I think he is already. Number 44. He's just one of the great linebackers that this college has turned out.
As a unit, the Sporting News says they're the fourth best in the country coming into this unit. Obviously, that's a very objective type rating. Who really knows? It's hard to measure in terms of a subjective rating. A&M right there with anybody. 3rd and 9. Too tall. Picked off. Patrick Bates, the transfer from UCLA.
Well, Bates almost looks as if he's too big to play back there. 6'4", 224 pounds, but he makes a great reaction to the ball. He reads the quarterback's eyes in the pocket. He picks up the eyes, and you'll see him come in. He's already reacting to the ball. As the ball is thrown right there, the quarterback looks right at the receiver, and you'll see Bates come into your screen right there. That's great safety reaction once the ball is thrown.
It glanced off the fingertips of Wesley Jacob. And a very, very unpromising start back home for Curly Holman. Gross, 2 or 3 yards at fullback. New tailback is in, Randy Simmons, giving Greg Hill a breather. R.C. Slocum and Curly Holman coached together on this Texas A&M staff for 6 years during the decade of the 80s. Holman then took over at Southern Mississippi. R.C. says he's a good friend, a lot of respect as a person and as a coach, and he is fully expecting this LSU program to turn around. They were 5-6 in Mike Archer's last season last year. 2nd and 8. And caught in the backfield, Wilbert Biggins. They blow him down at the 38-yard line.
I want to tell you, that's an interesting play to me. Why you call a reverse in a situation like that, I don't know. Unless you totally think that you're going to catch him by surprise, but they're blowing him off the line. They're picking up 6-7 yards every time they carry. This is a slow reacting play, and you'll see one of the linemen get right there. Boom. That's just too slow a reacting play. There's the knee down. That's why the whistle was blown.
Well, they want to get Wilbert Biggins involved early. They've got him returning kicks. They've got him at wideout. He was one of the highly touted high school running backs in Texas last year, but you've already seen what type of depth A&M has at that position. Petty in trouble, and he's dropped back at the 46-yard line. Corey White on a blitz from outside linebacker. The LSU defense stiffening. What's different compared to the first A&M series?
Well, I think two things. First of all, you lose your leadership. The timing is different with a new quarterback in there, and your linemen have to make that adjustment to that different cadence call. Obviously, they don't have as much confidence in a Kent Petty as they do Bucky Richardson, but I would really question that reverse. You're blowing them off the line. You're getting 6-7 yards a carry. They're averaging almost 10 yards on that first down. I just keep on running the ball.
The new Aggie punter is David Davis. He played six-man football in West Texas at Loop. And Todd Kinchin, the All-SEC return man and wide receiver, who single-handedly beat the Aggies in Baton Rouge last year. And he's going to stay in the game. We expected to see a lot of the guys who were demoted this week. And one by one, Holman working him back in. Not much in the way of field position, however. They start just outside their own 10-yard line. Eagle remains the quarterback. Darryl Williams, Harvey Williams' brother. Harvey, the first-round pick of Kansas City, in the backfield along with Odell Beckham. Daigle still has it on the option. He'll keep, and he'll get nailed at the 15. That's Bates coming off the interception.
Well, when R.C. Slocum saw Patrick Bates, he said, I thought he was a coach on the other team. He was so big. And he runs through you. That's the mark of a great defensive back in tackling, is when they run through you. Now watch Bates come into your picture. He's going to come right in here. Bam. That's just all-out tackling. That's the way you tackle. You don't tackle to somebody. You tackle through them.
Not many 224-pound college safeties, or pro safeties for that matter. Darryl Williams. And Jason Atkinson from inside linebacker leading that Aggie surge. Going to be third and still about three for the Tigers.
And if I was Daigle, I would call a real safe play here. I'd look for my tight end delay. I might roll out a little bit to get that run pass option, but I'd get out of all that pressure. I'd try to get outside so I'm not under that pressure. I can pick up my receivers.
Carter right, Jacob left. Flag down as the whistles blow prior to the handoff to Beckham. And procedure LSU.
Well, that play wasn't going anywhere, so they may be lucky on that. They may get another chance at third down because that play was sniffed out right on the line, and it was going nowhere.
Only four penalties last week.
Offense, third down.
Their problems lay elsewhere. They were really shocked that Georgia never noticed a throwing team threw for 305 yards against them. That's the most since 1972 for a Georgia offense, and that's against one of the best secondaries in the nation. Or so we thought. That may have to be rethought.
Well, this is a big down. Third down. You don't want to punt from this deep in your own territory. LSU needs that first down.
Daigle, good protection. Caught. Kinchin needs the 20. First down. And the obvious question, why is this man not starting? He got 19 yards on third down.
I almost thought he made a mistake, though, when he kind of angled back inside the 20. A receiver has to know how many yards he's going to he needs for that first down. Kinchin gets it right here. If he just turns up, gets first down, but he kind of bends around. Now, get past the 20, and he picks up yardage. I think his benching is he's unbenched. I think he's back now.
Well, the benching is because he fumbled it twice last week, and Holman making a statement about the import of hanging on to the ball. That statement lasted less than one quarter. Odell Beckham has some holes finally start to open up in the LSU offensive line. Into the secondary, Crooms made the tackle.
You know, Dave, we talked about Kinchin and the effect he has on this team when he's out there playing. Look at this, Mr. Superman in high school.
Could you do more than he did in high school? Football MVP, state champion in basketball, state champion in baseball, regional finalist in tennis, all district in track. Apparently not time for golf.
Five letters.
That's... Oh, not just letters.
That's right. Yeah, that's right.
Second and five, flags again. And Jermaine Williams, last week's fullback starter, handles it for the first time this week. Boy, a team that only had four penalties last week starts off this week very sloppy.
Well, first of all, when you make that many changes, you don't have continuity. Everybody's new. The guard moved over the tackle moved back up third. He's going to be back up. They just switched all over the place and got new people trying to learn new cadence and new game conditions. And when you get down on that line, it's not like you just get down if you're an offensive lineman and say, okay, the snap counts on two. You've got to pick up the call by the center. You've got to see the man you're blocking. You have to remember what play it is. There's a lot of thinking that goes on when you line up in an offensive lineman position.
Clock rolls. It'll be second and 10. We're near the 1 minute mark in the first quarter. Through the hands of Odell Beckham. Had he held on, probably no gain, and it would still be third and 10. Pressure came that time from Kevin Tucker. Cut off just before Tucker arrived. Tucker off an ankle injury, which has limited his action in the last year or so.
Well, I'll tell you what I'd do. I'd come back to Kinchin again. I'd look for him on that crossing pattern that they were successful last time.
He's the only thing close to a go-to receiver they have. And he's wide left. Eagle goes that way. Too tall. Had him man on man. Marlon Haynes. Step for step, and Kinchin says, hey, he interfered, and they'll flag Kinchin for his protest.
Oh, that's wrong. You don't do that. And I can tell you this, Curly Holman will not like that. You don't go back and make a gesture like that an official. You have to keep your composure. And that's what he's calling him over there, saying, never lose your composure.
Ball wasn't catchable. And I didn't see interference, even if it had been catchable. We'll take a look here.
Well, I think it was more off the line. You can see the ball's over his finger. He was saying that he was interfered as he came off the line of scrimmage. See, he doesn't run to this referee here. The one right here makes the no call. He runs all the way back to the one on the line.
Well, that was Derek Frazier, the quarterback, that he says held him on the line. That protest to no avail, and it's fourth and 25 for Brian Griffith.
He's fortunate he didn't get thrown out of the game. I thought for a second there he swung at the official. Kind of giving him an, get out of here.
Aggies play for the return this time with another low spiral and another fumbled return effort by Biggins. Through the first wall and near midfield.
Boy, if he could catch the ball on the punt, he'd pick up an extra 2 or 3 seconds.
Well, he's making things happen. Something's happened. It's not always good, but whenever he touches the ball, something is happening for Wilbert Biggin.
Well, once you fumble the ball like this, you have to think, I got to get the ball now. Pick up your blocks. And he sees right straight up the middle of the field, he's going to pick up the most yardage. That is some nice cutting in there.
True freshman Wilbert Biggins out of Aldine MacArthur. Simmons and Gross in the backfield as Petty remains the quarterback. If you just joined us and you're wondering, what about Bucky Richardson? Well, sprained foot has kept him out from about half this quarter after Randy Simmons carries on first down. And a sprained ankle has kept the starting fullback Doug Carter on the bench for about the last 5 minutes of clock time.
Well, look for A&M to get very basic, get back to that run game that they've controlled this first half with. Get down there, drive the football, rely on those big linemen blowing off the line.
Play action, second and 8. Petty wants to go deep. Harrison, first down, inside the 30 of LSU.
I'm going to tell you, that was not a pretty pass. That ball wobbled all the way. But just an excellent catch. Now, the A&M coaches felt they could throw underneath on LSU. They felt LSU gave too much ground and they could throw the crossing patterns. That wasn't a pretty pass.
That's where Georgia got most of their yardage last week. That was 19 yards for Harrison on the final play of the first quarter. A&M 7-0 over LSU here in College Station.
Warner Cable brings the great sports performances home this fall with exclusive NFL football and ESPN every Sunday. Tackle the touchdown and we'll put you on the 50-yard line as the hot games explode. And right now, get standard service with HBO and Cinemax installed for $4.95. You'll have a ball with ESPN.
It's terrific.
Warner Cable. Great performances every day.
It's new. It's hot. Come see what we've got at Fiesta this weekend. Fashion so low, so low, so low. At Fiesta this weekend.
This weekend, specials at Fiesta include T-bone steaks, only $2.99 a pound. Juicy California strawberries, just 49 cents a pint. And 32 ounces of Heinz ketchup for 69 cents.
Special food and fun, Fiesta weekends.
Dave Barnett and Dave Rowe at College Station. We're at 7-0 Texas A&M. And at the end of the first quarter, statistically, all Aggies. In fact, these numbers are going to make it look like they should be ahead by much more than only 7 points. 147 to 33 in total yards. Maybe they should be ahead by more than seven.
Well, I think they definitely should have 14 points. I think that reverse really hurt them because they were driving the ball, had good field position. That's really the only time they really had to give up the football.
A 12-mile-an-hour south wind behind Kent Petty as the second quarter unfolds. And a huge hole for Randy Simmons. First down, 18-yard line. Ivory Hilliard, the free safety, made the tackle.
Dave, when you're a defensive lineman and you can't shed the block, you're locked on them. That's what A&M is doing. They're locking on all the LSU defenders up front, and the back just comes up there and just kind of runs around them. You have to have vision to do that. But the LSU players are not shedding the blocks and getting over to where the play is running through.
Simmons, the lone setback. He'll get it. 10-6-yard line. First and goal, A&M. Randy Simmons from McKinney, Texas, right in your face here.
Well, see, now, there's a good example right there of not getting rid of the blocks. They're not getting off. LSU, the linemen, are not sliding across to the hole. And consequently, they're just running through there straight up. The backs are able to run straight up. They're not even bending over, smashing through.
This LSU secondary is going to be worn out by halftime. They're making all the stops. Simmons, right in.
Simmons get up limping after that play.
That's three ankle or foot injuries here in the first half.
Well, the first thing you would question is the AstroTurf. Is it slippery or is it too rigid? I was down on the field before the game. I didn't see anything different in the AstroTurf surface.
Well, as they now attend to Randy Simmons, Terry Venetulius, last year's kickoff specialist, this year handling all the placement duties, makes it 14-0.
Well, again, you just get behind those big blockers out there. This is just a simple sweep. See, both guards pull. Front back goes up in there, fullback picks up, and then you just look for the little seam. They push them all by, and he just skips into the end zone. Again, watch it here. Watch him just run. See the defensive lineman not getting rid of the blocks? Right there is the seam. The middle linebacker overruns it. Just jogs into the hole.
As old as Vince Lombardi's run to daylight theory.
When you play the game, you're looking good. That's the Bud Light way, yes, understood.
When you're looking good, you want Bud Light. The clean, fresh taste won't fill you up and never let you down.
You can taste it, you can feel it. You know you got it right.
Everything else is just the light.
Just keep your Bud Light shining.
Everything else is just the light.
You got the shine on.
Everything else is just the light.
How to improve your home involves some difficult decisions.
You know, we could use a bigger kitchen.
Nuh-uh. A new bath.
Uh-uh. Kitchen.
A new bath.
We could use a...
At NCNB, we don't think financing should be one of them.
Okay, a bath. Upstairs.
Upstairs?
That's why we've set up a loan information line. Call with your questions or stop by and see a loan specialist. Then tell us what's on your mind.
Okay, I got it. A garage.
Uh-uh. A deck.
A garage.
1-800-ASK-NCNB.
Sweetheart.
The loan source.
Yes?
I want a deck.
Once again, Buick is raising the banner for quality in America. Introducing the 1992 LeSabre. With a higher level of power, safety, security, and convenience. This new LeSabre is going to be one tough act to follow. LeSabre for 1992 from Buick.
Texas A&M averaging 9 yards on first down. And they lead 14-0 after the touchdown run by Randy Simmons. Our Schick Tracer storyline so far in today's game. LSU averaging 3 yards per play. A&M already 151 yards and 2 touchdowns on the ground, even despite the absence of Bucky Richardson for most of the game. R.C. Slocum has to be delighted with a 14-0 lead. Then Atulius will kick to Marcus Carter or Vincent Fuller. And from 4 yards deep, it's Fuller. Not the correct decision.
That's why you don't run it out from the end zone. You get it out to the 20 for free. You don't even have to not do anything. If you take it that deep, you've got 6 yards to get out of the end zone, and you make it out like he did to about the 13, maybe 16, 17-yard line.
Reveille on a hot September afternoon. A&M scoring drive didn't take long. Neither one has taken even 4 minutes. Simmons pushed it across. 14-0. Fuller stays in the game at tailback, and Jermaine Williams is the fullback. And he slams forward for a couple. Jermaine Williams, one of 6 Williamses on this LSU roster, will try as best we can to keep him separate. He's from Donaldsonville, Louisiana. He is the Louisiana High School all-time leading rusher, better than 8,000 yards in his career, and he gained 200 or more yards in 14 straight games in high school.
He'd start for me, too.
Well, they really need him to develop because they just don't have another Harvey Williams on tap at this point in that LSU backfield. Daigle on the roll. Wesley Jacob has the first down grab out of bounds at the 30-yard line.
And that's the way Daigle really needs to throw the ball because, as you mentioned earlier, he's only 5'11". Needs to roll out of that pocket. Get out there where he can look downfield. Here again, rolling weak side. Throws against his body, but again, just kind of squares up, finds his receiver. Nice delivery right to the seam, right to his receiver. That's what he needs to do. That's the way he can pass the ball effectively.
Jacob, one of 2 true freshmen to play 2 years ago for LSU. First and 10 from the 30. And another flag.
May have offsides by the center. I thought the center kind of snapped the ball a little bit and then kind of tried to bring it all the way through.
I think that's exactly what happened. LSU looking at a very young A&M team, and among their starters, this is including punters and kickers.
Dead ball.
On their two-deep chart,
by the offense.
13 seniors, 9 juniors, 15 sophomores. That's the class that's really going to be interesting to track through their career here, and 11 freshmen. Of the total roster here at A&M, 60 freshmen and sophomores. They had the tough recruiting year in 1989. They had the probation cloud hanging over them. They signed only 13 people that year. Boy, they made up for it the last couple of years. Cracked hard at the 34-yard line, Vincent Fuller and Quentin Coriat closed on him in a hurry.
I asked Alan Cannon there at the SID here at A&M, I said, now, how many linebackers have been drafted? They like to call themselves Linebacker University. Penn State's always had that so-called name. Every linebacker that has started here since 1985 has been drafted in the NFL.
Is that amazing?
That is amazing. And that's what Coriat said. He said, I know I'm going to get a chance to play in the NFL if I can start here.
Well, he's rated as the top senior linebacker by Mel Kiper Jr. coming into his final year at A&M. Fuller on the carry, nose guard Pat Henry on the tackle.
Well, I know it's got to be a happy day for Pat Henry to be in there, to have all the problems he's had. He's had that elbow problem. He had to have it operated on. He hasn't been at full strength, and now all of a sudden he can start and play. And he'll gain a lot more confidence in both his arm and his ability as he plays longer and longer. There he is, number 98.
Medical redshirt last year, dislocated his elbow in the Arkansas game 2 years ago. And they had to go back in and clean up some calcium deposits. That cost him all of last year. On the sweep, Fuller ran into his own man. Jason Smothers, the tight end, unwittingly helping on the tackle. Along with Steve Soleri. He transferred from Purdue, sat out last year. They have high hopes for this sophomore from Sugar Land, Willow Ridge.
Dave, you want to see how to play linebacker? Watch Coriat on this play. Look at this. Slide, slide, slide. Just keep on sliding. Stay square to the line. Sneak up in there and bam, help make the tackle. You want to keep perpendicular to the line. You want to slide. Don't turn and run. There he is, number 44. You're going to hear a lot about him this year.
Griffith the kick on 4th and 3. And for the first time, he has to deal into a 12-mile-an-hour wind. High snap. Nice hands, brought it down. This is an outstanding kick. Diggins from the 20 to the 40. First down, 43-yard line, a 22-yard return.
Anybody who ever returns the ball will tell you the best thing to do is don't run lateral. Find a little seam, get right upfield, and that's what Bagans does. He gets right upfield. Watch this. Once he looks the ball in, that's a high kick. Now watch, seam, bam, explode right up through the hole, get that plus yardage, get the ball upfield, and he does a great job.
4.5 speed in the 40, 36-inch vertical leap, all the makings of a great wide receiver. They may never have to line him up in the backfield. Jeff Granger is the quarterback for Texas A&M. And Greg Hill on the carry. This is the third quarterback the Aggies have played here in the first half. And boy, is there buzz about this guy. He is a redshirt freshman from Orange Field in Southeast Texas. He is maybe a better baseball prospect than a football prospect. He was on the USA Pan American team with a 90-mile-an-hour left-handed fastball slider combination. They're not sure at all whether they'll have him for 4 years in the football program because they expect an awful lot of major league interest after his junior year in the baseball draft. And he says he's willing to go both ways for as long as he can make it viable here at Texas A&M. Hill's going to be close, I think, about a yard short on second down. 14-0 Texas A&M as we pause for station identification from Kyle Field and College Station. Almost 70,000 on hand, 14-0 Texas A&M. About 5,000 made the trip from LSU. They have been noticeably silent, however, with 9:11 to play first half. Aggies keep slamming away with the tailback, and Hill has the first down. He needed only one. He got about 7.
Well, I've been right down in that position as a defensive lineman many, many times, and I know what it's like when you can't get rid of that offensive lineman, and that back just cuts on him, and you're smothered by him. Boy, it makes for a long day, and that it's going to be a long day unless LSU starts to slant their lineman, get him free of the blocks, and get him into the holes where the attack is.
Word now from the A&M benches, Doug Carter will not return. Sprained ankle will cost him the rest of the day. Long count by Granger. Inside the 5-yard line, Ryan Matthews. 41 yards.
This is an audible on this play, Dave. When Granger looked up, he saw the cornerback start to sneak in like he was going to blitz. He audibleized to it, saw Matthews out in the flat, and he was wide open. The safety tried to come over and cover him late. Again, see him looking over there? He calls the audible. There's the audible. See the offensive lineman moving? That's the audible. Now, look, he doesn't look anywhere else. He flips it up. The safety comes over trying to cover, and you see he's late getting there.
That's not bad. Your third college play, you have the presence of mind to audibleize into one-on-one coverage, and your first collegiate pass goes for 41 yards. Flags fly prior to the snap. And we'll have a mark off against the Aggies. Well, Bucky Richardson.
He may be able to sit down for the rest of the day.
He may not have to worry about the rest of the day.
Ball start, I thought R.C. Slough was very candid about Granger's future. He said, we'll approach that when we get to it. He said, he and I have talked about it. He said, he loves baseball, loves football. And he said, right now, coach, I'm content to do both.
So first and goal from the 7. 8:04 and a half. A&M looking to go up 3 touchdowns. Greg Hill. The Aggie sweep has been deadly. Touchdown.
You don't turn it in, it's murder. It's just murder out there. Well, Short got a great block, the tight end on that play. He drove his man off the line of scrimmage.
Greg Hill with his second touchdown of the half. Aggies favored by 2 touchdowns and looking a great deal better than that despite all the first half injuries. And Atulius adds another extra point and it's 21-0.
Well, 2 things again. The great block by the 10, the tight end, 86 Sharp. He's on the left of your screen. You probably won't see him until he gets in there, but he drives his man off the line right there. He's got him nailed. Now Hill kind of bends in, and then all of a sudden dips on out to the corner.
That's a 2+ block. Sharp got 2 Tigers out of the way. A&M 21-0, and we return after this message from Southwest Airlines.
I grew up in Texas.
On this, our 20th anniversary, Southwest Airlines proudly unfurls Lone Star One, a high-flying tribute to the indomitable spirit that makes Texas a true state of mind.
Shining in the Texas sky, the Lone Star is flying high.
Storm life, it's way too formal. Oh. Who needs soda pop that tastes too normal? No. Who cares about good taste? I know what tastes good.
No, tastes
while
good.
The best thing's always so misunderstood. Oh. Just give me what the doctor ordered.
Dr.
Just what the doctor ordered.
Hey, give me a Dr. Pepper.
It only takes a second for an accident to happen. Don't wreck your life.
You're Greg Hill. You're a freshman. You're playing your first half of college football. You've carried 11 times. You have 79 yards and two touchdowns.
And I say, well, nothing would make me happier than to get 100. I'm not going to be satisfied.
He didn't say 100 by halftime, but he's going to get there.
Boy, he made a great run on that time. Just timing was perfect. Run out there, just use that speed, slow down. All of a sudden, you see the corner open up and just burst inside. It was just a marvelous run.
Vanatulius kicks this one halfway to the Kolache Festival in Caldwell. That's about 20 miles from here. And the Tigers will start from their own 20. Next week on Raycom and Prime Network, the Aggies visit the Tulsa Golden Hurricane, and we'll have the first of this season Southwest Airlines Southwest Conference trivia questions. We look forward to being with you for the Aggies and the Golden Hurricane from Skelly Stadium in Tulsa next week. Meanwhile, Curly Holman has tried the shock therapy of changing half his starting lineups. Obviously, that has not helped. And he's now got a throw on first down. Marcus Carter out of the tackle. Nice job, and he'll be very close for a first down at the 30.
Well, I think Curly Holman's got to get back into his offensive driving technique and philosophy. He's kind of lost it. They've tried just about everything they can try. Now you got to get back to the basics. Got to get back to try to run and get first downs, get some confidence back in your line.
Three outstanding seasons at Southern Miss. Got him into the bowl picture. Mike Archer's replacement at LSU and looking straight at an 0-2 start. James Jacquette is the new tailback. Flags down. Jacquette held to a gain of maybe two if the play stands.
And you see the difference on the play there. You see those linemen slipping those blocks, getting off, and just smashing it in the hole.
It won't stand. Motion LSU. I've got to think the lack of continuity, so many different faces being mixed in back and forth for LSU is the reason we're seeing so many flags here in the first half.
I think you're absolutely right. But I still go back to this point.
Motion.
David Eddis.
Declined. Second down.
The difference is that 18 of these 22 starters for LSU beat Texas A&M last year. Don't think that wasn't a concern to the staff.
However, we should point out that, as Aggie fans remember, Darren Lewis was ejected in the second quarter of that game. Incident along the sideline, and in a low-scoring game, Todd Kinchin then took over, had a 79-yard touchdown on a 2-yard pass that he ran the last 77 yards, and then a big punt return. Daigle at the 32, out of bounds. Coriot chased him. And Daigle pops back up. You look at third and 8.
Well, watch Daigle get flushed out of the pocket. Now, by the time he gets back and sets up, look, pressure already. Now, once you put your head down, there's no way you're going to pull the ball back up and pass it. And he's just trying to get to the sidelines, get out of bounds.
Well, he does not have Kinchin in on third and 8. Carter inside of Jacob, wide left. Carl Hankton just out of your picture, wide right. And Daigle unloads with a flag down. Intended for Jacob. And that might not be a flag. That might be a towel he dropped. And it is fourth down.
Again, no time, Dave. He's sitting back in that pocket, and quarterbacks get what they call happy feet. You don't get planted in there. Your feet start jitterbugging around. He just is not standing back there with any confidence in delivering the ball. His man was open on the play, just didn't have time to get it to him.
Well, we'll see what happens with Mr. Biggins this time. Griffiths had a whale the first half punting. You saw an average of nearly 50 yards per kick. Aggies go for the block, and Buckley almost got it. This time cleanly handled by Biggins to the 42. And A&M again with outstanding field position. 6 minutes, 43 seconds in the first half of an Aggie blowout.
There is a new gasoline that is clearly advanced. A new gasoline that will give you the highest level of engine cleaning for high performance. A new gasoline formulated to clean fuel injectors and intake valves. Who has this new gasoline? You know who. New Phase 4 gasoline from Exxon. For cleaner engines and high performance.
Bud Light. The clean, fresh taste won't fill you up and never let you down.
Well, you can taste it, you can feel it, you know you got it right. Everything else is just the light. Just keep your Bud Light shining. Bud Light.
Once again, Buick is raising the banner for quality in America. Introducing the 1992 LeSabre. With a higher level of power, safety, security, and convenience. This new LeSabre is going to be one tough act to follow. LeSabre for 1992 from Buick.
Boy, R.C. Slocum obviously didn't want to see anybody hurt. He has had to use some youth because of injuries earlier than he anticipated, but he's got to be just overwhelmed by what he's seen from these freshmen.
When your third-team quarterback comes in and throws a pass like he did, you've got depth. And once you have depth, you can play football all day long.
So Jeff Granger,
I don't even know if I'd bring Bucky Richardson back, Dave.
Well, and Kent Petty, you know, he was effective while he was in, but Granger remains in. And they take over from the 42-yard line. They've had all the room they've wanted, straight up the middle. Ivory Hilliard making the tackle on Greg Hill. He's that much closer to the 100-yard mark. That's 12 carries, 86 yards here in the first half.
I don't even think he envisioned having 100 yards at halftime. Maybe he really did mean that he's going to win the Heisman this year.
Well, this in a backfield that has Randy Simmons, a senior, who averaged nearly 8 yards per carry last year, and Keith McAfee injured because of a hamstring pull. He's not expected to play this week and maybe not next week. Hill has the first down. This was supposed to be McAfee or Simmons coming into their own as a senior, but Hill is a freshman. May keep them on the bench except for spot duty.
I like the way Hill runs. Obviously, with the yardage, that's an easy thing to say. But when he sees the hole, he sees that opening, he just flies through it.
Well, they have just ground it out very methodically. 13 first down. They've mixed in the pass precisely the way Slocum told us yesterday he wants to set up the run. Only when it's there and not as the major part of his attack. 4 yards on first down for him.
I thought it was interesting, too, what he said yesterday about the change in the philosophy on offense next year after Bucky Richardson leaves. He said, we won't be the great option team that we've been with Bucky. He said, we'll be more of a strong running, power running play team. A little bit of pass mixed up because we've got a quarterback that can throw the ball much better than Bucky can.
Trick play, quick snap. And out of bounds at the 5-yard line is Rodney Thomas. One of the two top recruits in the state of Texas last year out of Little Groveton in southeast Texas. Hello, college football. Rodney Thomas takes it down to first and goal.
Now realize, too, this is your third team running back. Again, quick, just out the outside, uses that speed, 38-yard run.
Swinging gait. R.C. Slocum has closed practices right up through yesterday's workout in shorts and sweats, and he says, I've got some things in store I don't want Curly Hallman to know about. That, obviously, is what he had in mind. Hill back in, going for his third touchdown of the first half, and he didn't quite get there. He's about a foot shy. Hilliard and Boutte on the tackle for LSU. Very un-Aggie-like, that type of razzle-dazzle in the first half.
You know what's amazing? As a player, you love things like that. The offensive linemen, they love to do gadgets like that because most time They're just smack face football, just power straight ahead. They love to see reverses and swinging gates, the old fumble rooski play, those type of things. They just get a real joy out of that.
If he scores, he's at the century mark. Timeout, LSU. They've got more than a few things to discuss. 4:41 in the first half. And if the Aggies go up 28-0, so long. This thing's over, if it's not already. From the start today, the musts that we discussed for Texas A&M have all come into play here. They have dominated. They haven't made very many mistakes of youth, and it's obviously been GHT.
Yes, it certainly has. They've done everything right. That's why they're leading 21-0. Conversely, for LSU, it's been just they haven't done anything right.
They did not get a quick start. They have not gained any confidence or continuity. Hard to put it on Daigle. We haven't seen Loop here in the first half because no one has performed for them.
No, you can't blame a quarterback when your offensive team's not running. A lot of people look to the quarterback, but the quarterback is only as good as his line blocking gives him time to pass, and the running backs are only as good as that line opening up the holes.
Second and a foot. Keeper, Granger, touchdown.
Don't have to get fancy when you've got an offensive line that's controlling the line of scrimmage.
27-0. Venatulius for his fourth extra point. Good look at the new narrower goal posts in college football this year. And Venatulius is 4 for 4.
Again, you don't have to be fancy. Just leave those big offensive linemen blow through there. You see the center getting off well. They're just controlling it. They're just a surge there of maroon jerseys just blowing them off the line.
Well, we saw Bucky Richardson for about half the first quarter. He sprained his foot. We were told, and we haven't been told differently, that he would probably be able to return. But if you're R.C. Slocum, do you want to mess with Richardson with things flowing so smoothly for Jeff Granger? Do you just let Bucky take the rest of the day off?
If it's any kind of an injury that will last more than 2 or 3 days, no. You just sit him down there and you rest him. You use Granger. Well, you know that Aggie tradition. Every time they score, the girls get kissed in the stands. They're going to wear out those girls' lips today.
Oh, no. No. They come ready for that.
I bet they like high-scoring games.
Always wondered why schools that have the tradition of the mascot doing push-ups don't go to this tradition. This is something to look forward to. Carter from the 8. Mashed at the 15. Reggie Graham made the special teams hit for A&M.
Here's the 12th man, Jay Elliott. Watch him go down. You know the 12th man tradition here. He's just flying down, too.
Now, they've changed from having an all walk-on unit to having one 12th man wearing number 12, representing the 12th man tradition. And it's Jay Elliott today. Well, we see a new quarterback. Not surprisingly, Chad Loop will get a crack from the 15-yard line, replacing Jesse Daigle. He is the better passer of the two, and he throws it away. Intercepted by Otis Neely.
There's a flag on the play, Dave, but I think it's a piling on flag after he was down.
Ball was intended for Beckham circling out of the backfield, and the personal foul after the interception against LSU.
This was supposed to be a quick pass, and Loop never got set on the play. He got some pressure, but he just never got his feet set, and he kind of hesitated 2 or 3 times to throw the ball. Let's watch him again. Watch him here. It's a quick play out to the flat here. He just never kind of gets set. See right there? He kind of throws as he's going back under pressure. Great reaction. There's the penalty afterwards, the piling on.
Delia Jr. from Lamarck, two-time All-State man there. Two-year letterman here. Second Tiger turnover sets up the Aggies. First and goal at the five-yard line with 4:27 to play in the half. Bidding to go up 35-0. Gross and Hill split backs behind Jeff Granger. Rolls right, left-hander in the flat, all alone. Cliff Gross for the touchdown. You can't go home again.
Well, I can tell you, for Curly Holman, he's looking for people right now. He says, I want people that are going to be winners. I'm looking for people that are not going to quit in this situation. But he's got an avalanche coming down on him.
They're going to wear out Terry Venetulius. Five out of five. 35-0.
Boy, great fake into the line there by Granger to hold him. Watch right here. Great fake. Right there, boom, he comes back out. Just a little short roll. The left-hander finds him out in the flat. Everybody was thinking run then. And boy, when you establish a run, then you can go run, pass, whatever you want, and you really keep the defense off guard.
Freshman to freshman there. Granger redshirted last year. Gross, a true freshman from A&M Consolidated High School here in College Station. Hill, a freshman. Rodney Thomas, a freshman. Wilbert Biggins, a freshman. Mercy. The rest of the Southwest Conference has some long days in store the next 3 or 4 years. It hasn't bothered Terry Venetulius today, but you've probably become aware that that is the NFL distance between uprights. The old college distance narrowed from 23-4 to 18-6 this year. I don't see it having a whole lot of impact on the games I've seen so far.
Well, I think it has impact when you get in close and try that short field goal because the angle is much different. But you're right, it hasn't affected them a whole lot. Interesting, I saw where Roman Anderson practices on a 9-yard wide goalpost. 9 feet wide goalpost. That's a nice way to practice. If you make that, it must look like that other one spread out as wide as can be when he kicks a regular one.
Well, they need a holder because of the breeze, and Venetulius will pin Fuller in the corner of the end zone. 4:22 in the first half. LSU trailing 35-0. This, of course, is one of the proudest traditions in the SEC. This is not a program that is used to being down, being blown out in the first half, nor will they ever get used to it.
Well, I think Holman had quite a job to come in. He had to change his entire team around from what it had been under Mike Archer. They said it was not a disciplined team. People were late for meetings. They were late for practice. They just had that lackadaisical attitude. So he had to come in and completely change the composure of this team.
Roop remains the quarterback. At the 10-yard line, James Jacquette buried by Mark Wheeler.
Now I'll tell you, as a defensive lineman, this is a blast if you're a defensive lineman. You can see right there, Wheeler just 97, just comes around the center, all the way around the backside and makes the tackle. It's just so much fun to play out there when you're a defensive lineman. You got a big lead like this. If you mess up one time, like you take a pass rush and you're not supposed to, nothing happens. It doesn't bother you. Coaches don't complain about it.
Nothing new for the Aggies. Every year since 85, they're top three in the conference, top 19 in the country defensively. Root sacked at the 12. Marcus Buckley, the outside linebacker from Fort Worth Eastern Hills. They figure Buckley to be the next great blitzing outside linebacker here.
When you look at the company that he's keeping, the Ropers and Wallace and Thomas, Holland, he's in some great company.
His father died last month. He had emphysema. He has dedicated the rest of the season to the memory of his father. And he says, boy, does that make me appreciate what I'm able to do physically. My father couldn't even come see me play. Fumbled out of bounds, incomplete, intended for Carter. But back to Buckley. He says, my father couldn't come see me because he couldn't physically withstand walking to a seat in the stadium. It really gives me a perspective on the athletic talents I and my friends have been blessed with.
Well, with 2 minutes and 57 seconds left in this half, the fans here in Aggieland know that they're going to get great field position. They'll get the ball at midfield again.
Griffith from his own end zone. Biggins near midfield. And again, Biggins has trouble, fumbles it away, flag down. LSU has the recovery. Mike Garrett fell on it for the Tigers, but we'll see what the indication is.
Well, Dave, I can tell you, when they bring him over the sideline, they're going to tell him this. There's sometimes you have got to look the ball in and fair catch. That was not a long enough punt. The coverage was down there in his face, and he just tried to run up and catch it on the run. Sometimes you'd have to do the wise thing. Fair catch, they would have had the ball on about the 44, 45-yard line.
Everybody takes a deep breath whenever Wilbert Biggins steps on the field here in the first half. The good, the bad, the talent, and the inexperience. We've seen it all. And the indication is against the Aggies.
This is going to be about the best field position I think I've seen LSU
flipping
have all day long.
Receiving team declined. First down.
Well, again, Dave, you've got to know when to just fair catches. Watch how quickly the coverage gets in. Now, he's making an effort to catch it, but you'll see yellow shirts right in the picture, right there. See the yellow shirts already coming in? That's the ball that you want to fair catch and just take the great field position. There you are, the white shirts all over the place.
Plenty of time, 2:49 in the first half. Loop swarmed and dropped. Wheeler with the sack. Jason Atkinson wasn't far behind. Chad Loop, unlike Daigle, is getting teed off on because the Aggies know he's throwing every down.
No place to go. Look at this hit. Bam. Well, that's the way they teach you to tackle. Just wrap them arms, put that helmet right on the spot, and they are really teeing off now.
Loss of six, second and 16. Flags on what may be delay of game, LSU.
I thought I saw Neely point to someone, one of the offensive backs, moving. Yes, that's what it is. That's the call. I saw Neely just at the last second point say, wait a minute, he's moving. Not the only thing they haven't done is make the calls today, that linebacking core.
Well, so much for momentum. Recover a fumble punt. First down, sack, second down, five-yard marker. Even the breaks, backing up on Holman now. That's their sixth penalty after four all of last week at Georgia. Short drop this time, and overthrown behind Todd Kinchin. He had the right idea. He was one-on-one with Derek Frazier, but he threw it over the wrong shoulder. And I've got to think if there's any way they're going to get back in the game, Kinchin's got to be right in the middle of it.
Well, I certainly think so, and I think that's a safe pass. If you can get Kinchin one-on-one, he may be able to break one. He's really their speed out at the wideouts. And Loop laid that ball up. He's going to have to throw those lofting passes because he just doesn't have the time to sit back there and pick out his receivers.
Well, the play that broke it open last year in this game was just a two-yard out, and then his maneuverability after the catch is what took him the rest of the 79 yards. We haven't seen him run that play yet. A little bit surprising. Loop scrambling. And out of bounds at the 48-yard line on third down. He would still need five on fourth down. Kerry Vincent from right corner chased him out. We pause briefly for station identification. This is Raycom. With Dave Rowe, Dave Barnett from Kyle Field and College Station, where it's an Aggie runaway. 35 to nothing with a minute 44 in the first half, and on fourth down and six, Ryan Griffith will kick it away. LSU unable to capitalize on the break. Wilbert Biggins breathing easier after fumbling the punt near midfield. And Derek Frazier, rather than Biggins, is deep for A&M, and he wisely let that one bounce. Going to be downed, or is it? Nope, they couldn't get it. What, does that sum up the first half, or what? Should have pinned him back at the one. Instead, it's a touchback at the 20.
That's just a big mistake. They had a chance to get that ball actually at the 1 or 2 yard line. They didn't get into position. He stumbles over top of the ball. Boy, that'll cause you to pull off your hair, pull your hat off and pull your hair out.
I don't know that one man can do as much coaching as is required in a game like this. Kent Petty back in at quarterback with a minute 16. Jeff Granger in for two series and two touchdowns. On the ground, this is Thomas. Second effort for about 9 yards. Rodney Thomas played on back-to-back Class 2A state champions at Groveton, gained better than 8,000 yards, scored 111 touchdowns, and among other teams turned down LSU to sign with the Aggies.
He's the third team. Boy, standing back there, he's just, they've got talent so deep.
This time they wrap him up. And it may be close. He needed the 30 for the first down. 36 seconds. Rodney Young made the tackle. Might need a measurement.
I think if you're a running back, I think you want to come to Texas A&M. Because I look at what they've done in the running rushing department last year, of course, set that record rushing. If you're a great running back, you know you're going to get a chance to run the football here. And as R.C. Slocum told us, the good running backs, they answer the call. They don't care about who's there. They just come out and they say, hey, I want my chance. You're just going to give me one.
Well, we asked him that yesterday. We said, do you think rival recruiters hit Rodney Thomas with the argument that you wouldn't get playing time with Greg Hill coming in as a redshirt freshman? Said Rodney Thomas doesn't care. He just wants to contribute. He figures, give me a chance, I'll find a way to contribute. And R.C. Slocum here in the first half giving him a chance. As time runs out mercifully on LSU. Texas A&M 35-0 at halftime in College Station. Southwest Conference football on Raycon is being brought to you by Southwest Airlines. By Budweiser, remember, friends know when to say when. By Norwegian Cruise Line. By Exxon. By Buick. And by the Texas Department of Highways. Drive safely. Don't wreck your life. If you're an Aggie fan, you didn't picture this in your wildest dreams. 35-0 over your interconference rivals from the SEC, Louisiana State. Greg Hill, 99 yards and two touchdowns, the individual star. Among a galaxy of young stars in this first half for Texas A&M. We'll have halftime activities from Kyle Field in a moment.
At Texas A&M, I've been given the opportunity to work on real projects that aren't just for a grade. I'm gaining great experience.
Experience is important in and out of the classroom. Our physics students are hunting new particles at the Super Collider and building satellite technology at Texas A&M.
Texas A&M University has been demonstrating its commitment to education for over 115 years. Soon, we'll be the proud host of the nation's newest presidential library.
Texas A&M University, a leader in education in and out of the classroom.
Reintroducing a glorious name for a glorious new automobile, the 1992 Buick Roadmaster. With with its powerful V8 performance and the security of its driver's airbag, anti-lock brakes, and full perimeter frame, Roadmaster is perhaps the best value in an American luxury sedan. Roadmaster also delivers something only a Buick can deliver. Buick quality.
Larry Zonka, three straight Super Bowls. After that, he went to sea. Sports personalities, as well as our own team of sports instructors, help host Norwegian Cruise Line cruises. No other cruise line has such an all-star lineup. Norwegian Cruise Line, the best vacation you've ever had. Plus, contact with someone like number 39, Larry Zonka.
Ever since Southwest Air, our Friends Fly Free sale, people have gotten friendlier.
Sugar Plum, your favorite pillow.
If you make reservations and buy your round-trip ticket at our regular low unrestricted fare by October 31st, a friend gets to fly with you this fall, free.
Hey, Dad, seen the hedge trimmer?
You and a friend can travel through January 6th.
Here's that putter I borrowed last year, old buddy.
Southwest Airlines Friends Fly Free sale. It's great for your pocketbook and your popularity.
Buying a new car involves some difficult decisions.
Okay, let's see. Four-door? Not two-door.
Hey, maybe no doors. At NCNB, we don't think financing should be one of them.
Well, you gotta be kidding.
That's why we've set up a loan information line. Call with your questions or stop by and see a loan specialist.
Way too fast.
Then move on to the really difficult decisions.
Okay, red. No, blue. Maybe white.
1-800-ASK-NCNB.
Two-tone?
The loan source.
Great players and great teams are constant in the 77-year history of the Southwest Conference. Last year, over 2 million fans saw an offensive explosion as Southwest Conference teams set 22 national records. This fall, four schools are ranked in the top 25. And again, the conference boasts exceptional candidates for college football's highest honors. Call the Southwest Conference ticket hotline now, 1-800-800-SWC8.
The Aggies lead it here 35-0. Now let's go down to the field and listen to the Fighting Texas Aggie Band.
The network of college football's preseason classics. A full season of high-octane Southwest Conference action. Two of the top postseason bowl games. And all winter long, college basketball. For the best in sports, turn on Raycom.
Don't care about movie stars who live in Hollywood. Don't like their attitude, don't think I ever could. Don't want the good taste, I know I taste good. Why the best thing's always so misunderstood. Just give me what the doctor ordered. Just what the doctor ordered.
Just give me a doctor.
Come to the Isuzu Invitational, and you might discover that you're a stylish person. The Isuzu Stylus XS. It matches sleek sportiness with the safety of a standard driver's side airbag. Best of all, it's now up to $1,700 less. Get great savings on a sporty Isuzu Impulse, too. Only during the Isuzu Invitational, the perfect time to compare and save. Or really just save, because with Isuzu, there's no comparison. Save on Stylus at your local Houston area Isuzu dealer.
At America's finest hotels, you get such exceptional service, you hardly have to lift a finger. So it's no surprise that hotels who know so much about service like Hyatt choose AT&T. They know you depend on the quality and services of AT&T to perform at your best. Though admittedly, to appreciate our service, you do have to lift a finger. How can we help you?
Texas A&M 35-0 over LSU. Our guest at halftime is Malin Sutherland, the Associate Vice President for Student Services here at Texas A&M. And today, the beginning of several weeks of honoring former Texas A&M students who were involved in Desert Storm.
That's right, Dave. We have the opportunity to recognize all Aggies, including about 85 students and 25 faculty and staff members that were on active duty for Desert Storm. We're using all of the month of September to honor these men and women. We'll have special activities for the Southwest Louisiana game in 2 weeks, our next home game, and that will begin in the morning with a couple of dedication ceremonies to honor our three Aggies that were killed during that war over there. We will later in the day will culminate with a lot of activities here at Kyle Field. We're expecting a big crowd. We'll have a number of honored guests and look for a good time.
Any idea how many former A&M students were involved over there all told?
Over 500. We're pretty sure about the students because we also had the opportunity to offer scholarships that Mobile provided and our Association of Former Students. And we had about 40 students that have received those scholarships. Our Association of Former Students is sponsoring this weekend of activities in 2 weeks.
Hope everything goes well. We appreciate your spending some time with us today.
Thank you.
Malin Sutherland, Associate Vice President for Student Services here at Texas A&M. All Aggies in the first half. We'll have more here at Kyle Field at halftime in a moment.
Thank you.
The Exxon Southwest Conference Player of the Week is Leon Clay of TCU. The junior quarterback completed 18 of his last 21 passes for 253 yards and 4 touchdowns as the Horned Frogs routed New Mexico 60-7 in their season opener. For being Player of the Week, Exxon will donate $1,000 in Leon Clay's name to the Southwest Conference Scholarship Fund.
Great players and great teams are constant in the 77-year history of the Southwest Conference. Last year, over 2 million fans saw an offensive explosion as Southwest Conference teams set 22 national records. This fall, 4 schools are ranked in the top 25. And again, the conference boasts exceptional candidates for college football's highest honors. Call the Southwest Conference ticket hotline now, 1-800-800-SWCH.
I could have dropped out of school this year if money was the only thing that mattered. People said I was foolish to want another year of classes, to want to stay with my teammates. When I graduate, not only will I make money, I'll know how to make the money work for me. Staying in school can pay off in more ways than one.
This message provided by the NCAA.
Why Farm Bureau Insurance?
They look at your total insurance needs.
And develop what's best for you.
When you have a claim, Farm Bureau works hard to get you back on the road, fast.
If health problems interrupt your income, they can help keep you going.
Helping you is what we do best. That's why people across America, from every walk of life, depend on Farm Bureau Insurance.
Americans like you.
You don't even have to be a farmer. Just smart.
Most of my friends don't know what they're going to do after graduation, but I've already locked in guaranteed skill training in the Army. Qualify now and you can reserve even the Army's most sought-after technical training up to 12 months in advance through the Army's delayed entry program. Sure, being a soldier won't be easy, but then nothing worth having ever is.
Nothing, Texas A&M, the first half dominated by the youth that we talked about at the top of the show, beginning with GHT. It's been GHT just about from the first snap of the day for Texas A&M.
I don't even think he envisioned getting 100 yards in the first half. That's just amazing. But Greg Hill, we said you'd know his name after the game. You know it now at halftime. What a starting run, 22-yard touchdown run. It was just a wonderful run. He ran around.
Among his highlights, and he's got a couple of touchdowns. He's got 99 yards officially on 15 carries. And this was the first, 22 yards, A&M off to the early 7-0 lead. Among the old-timers for Texas A&M, we haven't seen that much, but Randy Simmons, the senior from McKinney, on the first of three straight carries, the third being a touchdown, carries for 12 yards here.
And Simmons, when you have your offensive line blocking like that, just about anybody can run up there for big yardage. Simmons, great leg drive. Look at this. Never quits, gets his feet out, stretches out for that extra yard or two.
On the third college play of the career of Jeff Granger, he changed the play at the line. He saw a one-on-one situation for another freshman, Ryan Matthews, on the left side as the wideout, and he had the presence of mind as a freshman, mind you, in his first series straight off the bench to change the play, and he went for 41 yards.
Well, you see him calling the audible. See the offensive guard look up at him. He hears a strange call. He knows it's an audible. The corner was blitzing. The safety came over. Granger read it perfect, and you cannot throw the ball any better on the dead run than that.
This set up Greg Hill's second touchdown run, and Granger wasn't done yet. Aggies had a little razzle-dazzle in their back pocket. They ran the swinging gate play.
And the swinging gate is the quarterback comes up to the line and just snaps the ball and snaps it back. All the linemen are on one side. It catches the defense by surprise. You can see the results right down the sideline.
For Rodney Thomas, the true freshman from Groveton. So the Aggies lead here 35-0. Time for this week's Budweiser Top 10 report. Number one, at home against Western Michigan tonight, Florida State with number two, Miami, solidifying that ranking by blowing out Houston Thursday night. Big Notre Dame, number seven, number three, Michigan.
Washington, Nebraska, they're idle this week, but they'll play on the 21st next week. Penn State at Southern Cal tonight, as is Alabama and Florida.
Eighth-ranked Washington, idle. They take on Temple later. Number nine, Oklahoma at home later against Division I, 2A, North Texas. Our score, 35-0, Aggies. Back in College Station after this. This week's Southwest Conference classroom champion is Greg Lakin of Texas A&M. The senior offensive lineman is a two-time member of the Southwest Conference Academic Honor Team, majoring in speech communication. He knows the commitment it takes to be a success.
Every athlete has to perform in both the classroom and on the field. And going to class every day is essential, just like practicing every day is essential. And if it means losing a few hours of sleep, then that's what has to be done. And if it means having to stay in after the game, that's what has to be done in order to achieve the goal of, excelling both in the field and in the classroom.
Who needs dorm life that's way too formal? Who needs soda pop that tastes too normal? Who cares about good taste? I know what tastes good. While the best thing's always so misunderstood. Just give me what the doctor ordered. Just what the doctor ordered.
Give me a doctor.
your face were square, shaving would be simple. If your face were flat, any razor would do. But your face has curves. You need the revolutionary Schick Tracer, the first razor with a blade that flexes to trace every curve on your face. Compared to other razors, Tracer puts more of the blade edge against your skin. For real faces, just like yours. Tracer from Schick traces every curve on your face.
Accidents happen when you're in a hurry and not careful. Don't wreck your life.
Just about ready to start the second half with the Aggies on top 35-0 over LSU. The numbers are going to bear that out. In the first quarter, the statistical difference made it look like it should have been more than 7-0 A&M over LSU. Now it really does bear out the difference on the scoreboard, especially when you look at rushing yards and total yards.
Well, the time of possession is the only thing that LSU has any closeness in. But look at the number of yards, total yards, 307-72. Their defense has shut them down. Their offense has driven down the field. They've just controlled the entire first half of this football game.
And the Aggies looking for more as they prepare for the start of the second half in College Station.
How to improve your home involves some difficult decisions.
You know, we could use a bigger kitchen.
Nuh-uh. A new bath.
Kitchen.
A new bath.
We could use a...
At NCNB, we don't think financing should be one of them.
Okay, a bath. Upstairs.
Upstairs?
That's why we've set up a loan information line. Call with your questions or stop by and see a loan specialist. Then tell us what's on your mind.
Okay, I got it. A garage.
A deck.
A garage.
1-800-ASK-NCNB.
Sweetheart.
The loan source.
Yes?
I want a deck.
Reintroducing a glorious name for a glorious new automobile, the 1992 Buick Roadmaster. With its powerful V8 performance and the security of its driver's airbag, anti-lock brakes, and full perimeter frame, Roadmaster is perhaps the best value in an American luxury sedan. Roadmaster also delivers something only a Buick can deliver: Buick quality.
Southwest Conference football on Raycon is being brought to you by Southwest Airlines, by Texas Farm Bureau, by Schick Tracer, and by Coors Light. They should all be this easy for Texas A&M. They won't be, but what a start for what is definitely a reloading program. We asked that question at the top. I think we've already seen our answer.
I think the rebuilding is over, if there was any chance of rebuilding. They are obviously reloaded, and they are reloaded strong. I'm really surprised, Dave, and we're going to see a lot of new faces in this lineup. And that's a great time for Texas A&M because they build that depth in that charge. Somebody gets hurt, you've got someone with playing experience who can come in and take over.
Jeff Granger getting his war paint on. He'll probably see much more action here in the second half. And among 5,000 or so LSU fans, one who can manage a smile. He'll have to tee it up again, as Matt Huerkamp, the true freshman kicker, kicking for Pedro Suarez, who was sent home after violating team rules last night.
Let's go,
They keep their football in perspective, I guess. Those folks, at least.
Yeah. Well, this is a terrible situation if you're an LSU player. You're down 35 to nothing. You say, well, where do we go from here? But I'll tell you this. First thing they talked about in that locker room was having pride, because we know the LSU tradition over the number of years. They've had great teams. So they'll play with pride this second half.
Wilbert Biggins again has trouble with the handle. Wisely to a knee, 6 yards deep. Aggies go from their 20. Kent Petty back in at quarterback as we look at the Aggies' possessions in the first half. First drive, 8 plays and a touchdown. Three drives later, touchdown, 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 touchdown.
Look at the field position. Only one time did they get the ball inside their own 40-yard line. That's quite a tribute to the defense. Defense was able to hold LSU and get the ball back in great field position.
Not sure what the discussion is, but LSU has a flag down at their 41, and they were offsides. So after the deep kick, Aggies will make them do it again.
And I wish I had a dollar for every time I've seen this exact situation where you come back and you've just run a 60-yard sprint, 70-yard sprint downfield. They've downed the ball. Now you have to kick it over, and those guys are gasping for air. Coaches will tell you, take a deep breath, walk around a little bit, take your time setting the ball up, because you've got another 70-yard sprint. And most times, the return team gets a great return on that second kick.
Not a team with a lot of experience at being blown out. Last year, among 6 losses, they lost by 21 to Alabama, by 39 to Florida State. The year before that, 1988, they lost by 41 points to Miami of Florida. They're in for a worse look in the net the way this one is starting. Biggins just about nailed at the 20, lost the ball again, and the Tigers first and goal at the 5-yard line. I don't think we'll see Mr. Biggins back there anymore today. Juan Sandoya, the man who caused the fumble. And for LSU, it's Corey Raymond with the recovery.
I want to tell you, Biggins almost had his head taken off on this play. When he ran up into the wedge, someone came from the left side. Let's see if you can see it on the right side of your screen. See who just about takes his head off. Right there. Boom. Boy, that's a big-time hit.
Mike Steptoe. We said Sandoya, we should give Steptoe the credit. Raymond knocked out at the 5-yard line. We'll see if LSU can get anything going. On first down, they might get 2, but no more. Odell Beckham will be given the 4-yard line.
And I can tell you, for a defense, you love to be in this situation. If they score, you're still up 28 points. But right now in that defensive huddle, they're saying, hey, let's not let them score. Everybody give a little bit extra. This is when you really tell what your defense is like.
Rice looking for their first road non-conference win since Fred Goldsmith was in high school. Early 60s. Second and goal from the 4. Daigle, the quarterback, all alone. Caught, touchdown, Darrell Williams.
Well, that's a heads-up play by Daigle. Fake into the line, come out almost on a, just on like a little fake boot out strong side. Had someone in his face, just gathered his composure, found his receiver open.
We saw both LSU quarterbacks in the first half. Daigle, the first to get the Tigers on the board. And Darrell last year wore number 32. He has switched to his brother Harvey's number 22 for his senior year. Both heavily recruited by A&M out of Hempstead, Texas. 35-6. Hewer Camp for the extra point. Out of Daigle's hold, and he is good.
Again, Dave, great fake into the line there by Daigle to hold him. Right there, he fakes in. Now watch, just kind of hide that ball a little bit. Come out strong side. Now he gets pressure strong side. Just pulls up and finds his receiver out in the flat wide open.
Hindsight's always 20-20, but the Aggies now wish they hadn't let them kick the ball off again. It's 35-7.
If your face were square, shaving would be simple.
If your face were flat, any razor would do. But your face has curves. You need the revolutionary Schick Tracer, the first razor with a blade that flexes to trace every curve on your face. Compared to other razors, Tracer puts more of the blade edge against your skin. For real faces, just like yours. Tracer from Schick traces every curve on your face.
Because if you don't watch your figure, who will?
It's the right beer now.
Because when it comes to water, the only place to start is at the top.
It's the right beer now.
Because when the party's going full steam, you don't want to fill up. So reach for the beer that won't slow you down. The Silver Bullet.
Why Farm Bureau Insurance?
Our agent helps us get the right coverage.
So we're always protected.
When you have a claim, Farm Bureau works hard to help you get things back to normal.
They can help you with a plan to make your retirement years great years.
Helping you is what we do best. That's why people across America, from every walk of life, depend on Farm Bureau Insurance.
Americans like you.
And you don't even have to be a farmer.
I'm a little bit surprised, but Wilbert Biggins right back there. Now, he has only cleanly handled one kick, and he's recovered. He's been back for punts and kickoffs in his first collegiate game. Are you surprised that Slocum is putting him right back out there?
Well, this is an easy time to get experience. So when you're up 35-7, it's a real easy time. So I think that it's a good move for him. They'll tell him Monday when they start looking at these films and breaking them down, you've got to look the ball in more. Now, you can tell him all you want, but until he gets the actual kick to him, that's when you learn.
Does the right thing here. This is an easy second guess, but in such an important role. What do you think about a freshman returning kicks in his very first game?
Well, that is a little bit surprising. I look for I'm looking for a word to describe him. I look for the more conservative approach on those type plays. I want to get out that sure 20-yard line.
Kent Petty, one of three A&M quarterbacks to see first half action. Junior from Dallas Lake Highlands. Bucky Richardson and Doug Carter both being X-rayed. Neither has returned since they went out with ankle and foot injuries in the first half. At the 27-yard line. Good gain, and then Wayne Williams sent him right back the other way. We pause briefly for station identification. This is the Raycom Network. Near 70,000. We almost have a full house at Kyle Field in College Station this afternoon. They've loved what they've seen so far. Their Aggies on top 35-7. Second down and three. Greg Hill again, this time to the 30. He'll be close, but not quite for the first down. Scott Wharton, the nose guard, 64 on the tackle, and Hill has already met his goal. He is over 100 yards.
Well, now you start second guessing and say, how long do you leave him in there? You're up 35-7. I think you leave him in there through the third quarter, pull him out in the fourth quarter so he doesn't get an injury.
Aggies send Brian Mitchell wide left. Two tight ends. On third down, Hill will lose a couple. Sean King, the outside linebacker, on the tackle. And the LSU defense making some halftime adjustments.
Well, they did make some halftime adjustments, but I think they're playing with a lot more emotion now. They've been thoroughly embarrassed. I'm sure they got torn to shreds in that locker room. They all took a deep look at each other and said, hey, we got to play for something. Let's play for pride. And these are the two best stands that they've made in the entire game.
Kinchin, with a nice return, could give them a little more to work with. He stands at his 35. David Davis for the second time to punt it away. Junior squad man from Loop, Texas. Good kick inside the 30. And nothing there for Kinchin. He's wrapped up by Otis Neely. A 44-yard kick and only a 2-yard return. And the Tigers will go from the 31. Next week, we've got the Aggies at Tulsa here on Raycom and Prime Network. Check your local listings as the Aggies and Tulsa will do battle in Skelly Stadium. Tulsa, pretty impressive start. They're 2-0. DJ Rubley back at quarterback for the Golden Hurricane under Dave Rader. And the Aggies apparently will have a head of steam and a 1-0 record, although we've got a lot of football yet to play. Odell Beckham tries to turn the corner. Good pursuit led by Chris Crooms from strong safety.
Well, Dave, I can promise you, if you were in that Aggie huddle right now, you'd be hearing, hey, we got to stop this momentum. You don't give up. You don't stop pouring it on until at least the end of the third quarter. People often say, well, aren't you running up the score? But you don't stop until at least the end of the third quarter, because there's a lot of teams have come back from deficits like this.
Daigle on the roll, a lot of time. Kinchin on the second effort is going to be very close, but I don't think has enough for the first down. And he took the hard way that time. He could have easily stepped out. Instead, he lowered his shoulder, and it might have given him an extra 2 or 3 feet, but he really got punished by Crooms along that sideline.
Well, I understand that Kinchin is the kind of guy, he's the kind of guy who'll climb a wall for you. That was what was, to me, was the real surprise when Curly Holman pulled him, because Kinchin is one of those gung-ho players. I mean, he gives it everything he has on every play.
Big play for the Tigers and a yard. And Beckham, I don't think, got it. The placement is everything. He needed about the 41 and a half. I don't know if he got it.
Boy, it's going to be awfully close. He got stood up straight in the hole. He tried to make a little side slant back to the strong side, but there was just nowhere to go. Watch him when he gets hit. He's straight up. He doesn't get a chance to bend over. You see how he's straight up? Atkinson in there just stood right in his face.
Well, they'll measure, but
well, if the lines are straight,
he looks to be about six inches short.
If the lines are straight on the field, which they usually are in AstroTurf, he's going to be short. Ooh.
Right again.
Well, what's an inch here or there? For LSU, it's a first down. I was kind of looking at the flag across the way there, and the guy had it about halfway, like you said, around the 41 and a half yard line.
LSU will take it. 11-10 and counting in the third quarter. They lead this all-time series 26-15-3. They've won four of the last five. Pass batted down at the line. This is just the seventh meeting at College Station between these two, and the Aggies lead here 4-1 and one tie. They discontinued the series between 76 and 85, picked it back up in 86. And the Tigers have dominated, including last year's 17-8 victory in Baton Rouge. And for the Aggies, it's really their version of Texas-Oklahoma. The recruiting wars in Southeast Texas, which arguably is the most fertile recruiting turf in America, always feature A&M head-to-head against LSU. It will not hurt them if they hang on to this blowout margin when it comes to signing time next February. Deep and way too deep, intended for Kinchin. And it'll be third down.
I think Daigle's got to go to a little safer play than that. You can throw it up one time to keep those backs honest, but right now he's got to be thinking first downs to keep a drive alive. If they're able to score here, their motions just continue.
Speaking of recruiting, 21 of the 23 Aggie recruits this year in the national top 100. Daigle roll out way over the head of Marcus Carter, and the Aggie defense holds again. He has not looked as sharp through the air as he did when he first came off the bench at Georgia last week. And I wouldn't be surprised if Holman goes back to Loop as a starter and Daigle off the bench next week, because from what we've seen here, Daigle appears to be more suited to that role. And that's an LSU tradition. They have always played a second quarterback.
Well, that was a huge series for A&M. I think they had to take a lot of the wind out of the sails of LSU. LSU had gotten two great breaks. They held them. Now they just now they're going to take back over on their offense, take control back in this football game.
A&M playing for the return. Griffith really gets into this one, and that will be a touchback. 58 yards off the toe of Brian Griffith. And we return after this from Southwest Airlines.
I grew up in Texas.
On this, our 20th anniversary, Southwest Airlines proudly unfurls Lone Star One, a high-flying tribute to the indomitable spirit that makes Texas a true state of mind.
Buying a new car involves some difficult decisions.
Okay, let's see. Four-door? Not two-door. Hey, maybe no doors.
At NCNB, we don't think financing should be one of them.
Well, you gotta be kidding.
That's why we've set up a loan information line. Call with your questions or stop by and see a loan specialist.
Way too fast.
Then move on to the really difficult decisions.
Okay, red. No, blue. Maybe white.
1-800-ASK-NCNB.
Two-tone?
The Loan Source.
Don't care about movie stars who live in Hollywood. Don't like the attitude, don't think I ever could. Don't want the good taste, I know I taste good. While the best thing's always so misunderstood. Just give me what the doctor ordered. Just what the doctor ordered.
Hey, give me a Dr. Pepper.
We want it.
Hey, Dr. Pepper. The taste is strange.
A&M ready to go from their 20, up 35-7. With 10:40 to play in the third period. And they have had big yardage every single time on first down. Five or six here for Greg Hill. And that does two things. Your offense is given a multitude of options because you have short yardage on second down. The defense, on the other hand, back on their heels on second down.
Absolutely. When you can't decide run pass, there's indecision throughout the entire defensive unit.
Much of the first half, A&M averaged 10 yards on first down. First down here for him, all the way to the 35. Anthony Marshall has been busy, too busy, if you're an LSU fan, from free safety.
Well, this is going to come right at you, but watch the cut that Hill makes once he gets to the line, all the way back over top of the center. His linemen are just blowing him off, and he's got that great vision backside to see that. Now, you don't think of that with a freshman. I want to be honest. You don't get that until you get experience. But Hill has that great vision backside, finds that little hole, and able to get those feet down to make that cut.
The natural comparison is to Darren Lewis, both from Dallas Carter, both here at A&M. The difference is quickness. Hill is quite a bit faster in flat-out foot speed. Similar moves, similar power. Lewis a little bit bigger. But R.C. Slocum says in terms of the ultimate potential, Greg Hill could be every bit as good as Darren Lewis.
And I think there was a great smoke screen here at Texas A&M about Darren Lewis's speed. I just don't think he had the speed. I think that's probably his biggest holdback. As far as a pro career, just doesn't have that flat out 4.5, 4.6 speed.
But he didn't need it, evidently. The only 5,000 yard rusher in Southwest Conference history. Play action, flags down. Petty Rowland looking. And nice footwork by Brian Mitchell, bringing that one in at the 46-yard line. It would be a first down. However, I think it's coming back for holding against A&M.
Now, let me tell you, you're going to see a longer than 10-yard penalty because where the flag was, if it is holding, it's from the point of the infraction. That was about 6 or 7 yards off the line of scrimmage. Watch again. I think you're going to see the hold right there in the middle. Now, watch him. See if he doesn't pull him down right here. That's the hold. Now, that's about 5 yards off the line of scrimmage. Then you tack on the additional 10 yards. That's the rule change this year. So you've got a 15-yard penalty instead of a 10-yard penalty.
Chris Dowson, the A&M center, with a hold of William Crowell that time. Colorado with the early 7-0 lead on Baylor. And is that ever a big game for the Southwest Conference? All day for Petty, lets it fly for Harrison, a double coverage and broken up. Ray Adams made the deflection. Adams, whose cousin Sam was a New England Patriot. Sam Adams. Yeah. Who ever heard that name before?
I played with Sam Adams in New England, and boy, did he have a talented son who came here. At any other school, he'd probably be starting. Here, he's a backup, but they're saying he has everything that it takes to be a first-team player.
We showed you that recruiting list a moment ago, 21 of their 23 signings on somebody's top 100 list. At the very top, that man, Sam Adams, Jr. And at this point, they don't need him, but boy, you will hear that name before he's done here. Harrison, almost a stretching grab at the 40. Ball just slightly overthrown. And it will be fourth down and 19.
You know, I asked Sam Adams Sr. about his son. He said, boy, he said, Dave, he must have gotten this talent from his mom. He said, because he said, he's bigger, he's stronger, he's faster, he's tougher. Of course, Sam was an offensive guard for New England Patriots for, I guess Sam probably played 10, 12 years. His son's a defensive lineman. And I said, where did he get this speed? He said, had to be from his mom.
And I think he's a little modest, don't you?
Yeah, Sam was a wonderful player. He was one of the hardest linemen to rush against because he had a great base.
Kenshin has had no room today, and Crooms chases him down, a net loss of 8 yards on the return. Big day for Chris Crooms on special teams and at strong safety.
Well, you know, it's interesting. You always think of coverage teams as using the players who don't start. However, with A&M, they use the starters. You see Crooms, he's a tackler. It's a starting defensive safety. He's on the special teams.
Kenshin back on the bench. Daigle remains the quarterback. Jarquette and Jermaine Williams behind him of the eye. And Daigle delivers. Jermaine Williams on the circle pattern out of the backfield for 16 yards.
Well, that was a good solid pass by Daigle. Got his base down, stepped into the ball, and just put it right on the mark.
Well, 1958, the last time the Tigers opened the season with two straight road games. All they did that year was win the national championship. The Chinese Bandits, who featured a guy named Gus Kinchin, Todd's father, a member of that national title crew under Paul Dietzel at Benton Rouge. Jarquette, all of a sudden, there is some running room up the middle.
Well, there was another guy in that 58 team. I'll never forget when I played with the Saints to start my career. Every Halloween night, they would run the famous Billy Cannon run. And I bet they still run it today.
Broke 7 tackles. And the little-known tidbit on that story is the radio engineer was trying to turn up the volume of the radio announcer to get him above the crowd noise, and he turned it the wrong way, and he turned him down. So much of that historic call is lost forever to history. Daigle deep, picked off. Patrick Bates has his second of the day. Flag down, Bates down at the 33. Bates pitched that ball off to Kevin Smith, and we'll see what the flags are about.
Well, I think you're going to find a clip on the play. I think the play will stand. There was a clip on the return, but Patrick Bates playing that center field position, reading that quarterback's eyes. The quarterback locks on his wide receiver. Bates comes over and just plays it perfect. You know, a lot of people have compared him to Atwater, and he does. He looks a lot like him, the same height, but he may be even stronger.
Flip it is. See if we can pick it up.
Now watch the quarterback lock in on his receiver over this side. Pulls up, sets up. Now see, he's looking at him all the way. And Bates, just standing back there playing free safety, just picks up the ball. Now you'll see the
Flipping, clip. During the run back, first down.
Now you won't see that. You won't see the clip, but you'll see a little lateral here. But doesn't Bates look a lot like Atwater, that tall safety position?
When Slocum first met Patrick Bates, as you said, he thought he was one of the Galveston Bowl High School assistant coaches. He started talking to him, said, "You're a little big to be a safety, aren't you?" Bates immediately reels off six guys his size playing safety in the NFL. He was ready for that question. Transfer from UCLA, making an early impact as the starting free safety here at A&M. Two interceptions today. Granger, the quarterback. GHT. Greg Hill up near midfield. Yards here, and Greg Hill has 157 for the day.
You see those two cuts right there? Someone right in his face cuts wide again, and he's outside before LSU can even recover. Whenever that running back runs up in the middle like that, it draws those linebackers in. If he's able to plant and get outside, that's where he picks up the big yardage.
He'll get a breather, and Rodney Thomas is the new tailback. Mitchell in motion. First man through is Gross. And one of the Tigers lost a helmet.
I thought there was a great story about Hill, about his little sister and how he came to Texas A&M. He had gotten a letter from Miami, from what I understand, and he and his friends were sitting there saying, "All right, Miami." And all of a sudden, his little six-year-old sister said, "Am I not going to be able to see you play?" And he said, "I knew I was going to stay nearby home."
Well, what does he do for an encore? You know, people are going to expect this every week from him. Thomas, look at that hole. And another A&M first out, and another Tiger loses a helmet again. Something symbolic about that on back-to-back play.
Well, you want to see what the safeties are looking at? They're looking at running backs coming right down their throat. Look at the hole open up. You drive the center man off. You kick the guard outside. You take them the way they want. I think I could run up in that hole.
You know, as amazing as this is, I think you could run up that hole. Anthony Marshall has saved four or five touchdowns today. Where would they be without him at free safety? 315 rushing yards. A&M off the Southwest Conference record year on the ground last year. They have not missed a beat. Cliff Gross on the carry. Thomas out, Hill back in on his quest for 200 yards.
Maybe he's getting an extra 100 just in case next week he doesn't get to play a whole lot.
I'm trying to remember, and I don't even know if there is such a record as most yards gained in a collegiate debut. I don't recall off the top of my head any first game producing a 200-yard by anyone. Not that it hasn't happened, but I don't remember. 5.5 minutes in the third quarter. Hill back to work. Two, maybe three. Finished off by Corey White. Something that he's had to contend with is his newfound status as a celebrity. Now you say, well, any Aggie player is a celebrity here on campus. But multiply that for him. There's been so much anticipation based on his practices as a redshirt last year, based on his 165 yards in the spring game. He's signing autographs in class. He said, "I got to try and keep my perspective about me because I haven't done anything today." Well, he has now. Gross. Inside the 15. 22 yards from Granger.
And that line just continues to give the quarterback time. It is so easy when you can mix up your plays and you've got a big lead and you've got that offensive line controlling the line of scrimmage. There's nobody putting a lot of pressure. They blitzed everybody on this play. See everybody getting picked up? Look at them just sitting out there, just nowhere to just toss it out there.
Big Cliff Gross, 5'11", 220, runs a 4.6 40. Athletic enough to return punts in high school, where he gained 3,000 yards his last 2 years. Flags down as the Aggies come to the line of scrimmage. Baylor on the board at Boulder. Southwest Conference watchers looked at this game and Baylor, Colorado, and they said, boy, A&M and Baylor have really got to carry the banner for the conference because Texas and Houston have stumbled out of the gate.
A lot of people say those two games were the image rebuilding games.
Well, what about Miami-Houston? How surprised were you?
I was very surprised. I really was. I thought Houston would be able to move the ball up and down the field. I knew the talent that Miami had, the speed that they had at the wideouts and skilled positions, but they totally got Houston out of the sink, and they just were not able to recover.
LSU closing the middle a little bit better, and they hold Hill to one, maybe two, on first and 15. Juan Sandoya made the tackle for Curley Holman. There was so much about the run and shoot, and does this mean the formation that John Jenkins says is unstoppable is just a fraud? I don't think it does, because I think if Miami had been running the run and shoot, they would have won 40-10. On the other hand, if Houston had been in a single wing, they would have lost 40-10. I think the formation had nothing to do with that. That was talent versus talent producing that type of runaway. Granger into the end zone for Biggins, underthrown. And the Aggie fans screaming for contact. Ivory Hilliard had the one-on-one coverage. No flag, third down.
You know, one note about that game with Miami-Houston, I thought that David Klingler kept his composure better than any player I've seen. A lot of people said, oh, he lost the Heisman on that particular game. But I thought he kept his composure, because everybody looks at the quarterback. He's the central figure in that run and shoot. But I thought his composure was just marvelous during the game when nothing was going right.
Well, that's the first incompletion by Granger. Third and 14. Tigers show blitz. Here they come. Granger got it off. And off the left hand of Gross. Tried to bring it in one hand. It couldn't do it. Granger hurried that time by Corey White. With whom he exchanges greetings.
Granger's just a freshman. He steps right up in his face and says, hey, give me one more chance. That's the way quarterbacks are. The great quarterbacks are the ones that they can be down. They could throw five interceptions, and they say, just give me one more chance, and I think I can take us down the field and score, coach.
Venatulius did not attempt any kicks as a freshman. In high school, he was 23 for 28. Out of the hole to Petty, this one will be 34 yards. Angle right to left. Plenty of leg into the wind, and he's good. The sophomore from Deer Park has been perfect today, and so have the Aggies.
Feels when you're way out there on your own tracking the bad guys. How it feels leading a skilled team that's the eyes and ears of the whole outfit. When all your training is coming alive. But finding those tanks and telling the air to be right where to hit them? I can tell you exactly how that feels.
If your face were square, shaving would be simple. If your face were flat, any razor would do. But your face has curves. You need the revolutionary Schick Tracer, the first razor with a blade that flexes to trace every curve on your face. Compared to other razors, Tracer puts more of the blade edge against your skin. For real faces, just like yours. Tracer from Schick traces every curve on your face.
Well, Dave, the sophistication of football even is in the blocking sleds. There's Tommy Tate, one of our cameramen, on the sled. Look, they even have
faces. He's wringing his neck.
Only Tommy Tate could come up with up close and personal photography like that.
Well,
and that's probably a good thing.
Well, we call him Scoop Tate for reasons that we can't go into.
Fuller and Carter deep for LSU, now down 38-7 with 3:18 to play, third quarter. It's already seemed like a 4 or 5 hour nightmare for the Tigers. And it's not over yet. High kick. kick. Fuller from the 15. Looks for a wall. Down at the 28. We're pleased to welcome those of you joining us on Prime Network and its nationwide family of regional sports cable networks. Scoring drive for the Aggies, leading to the Venatulius 34-yard field goal. Covered 9 plays and 75 yards. He is 5 for 5 on extra points and 1 for 1 on field goals. And Chad Loop back in at quarterback for LSU. His first collegiate start was against the Aggies last year. He was 10 out of 13 through the air, 152 yards. Led the 17-8 Tiger victory. What a difference a year makes. Wesley Jacob dragged out of bounds at the 45-yard line by Ramsey Bradbury. 17 yards on the connection from Chad Loop.
This is a nice play by Loop. He's getting back to the basics. A little quick out, picks up a receiver there, gets a good block, picks up yardage. This is what you have to do when you're down 38-7. You have to find the basics. You've got to say, okay, this game for all intent and purposes is out of reach, but next week is another week. We need to start building from right here. Run proper plays, run good plays.
A&M calls time. Might not have had enough men on the field or the right division of positions on the field. Right now, let's pause briefly for station identification. This is the Raycom Network. In the third quarter at Kyle Field. Dave Barnett, Dave Rowe, 38-7, Texas A&M. In their latest season opener in a number of years and one of the most successful season openers ever. In no way, shape, or form did they expect this type of a route, 35-0 halftime lead over a team with the history, the tradition that the LSU Tigers have. But they're used to knocking off the greats. Since 1985, they've played 5 eventual Heisman Trophy winners, and they've come away with 4 victories in the Cotton Bowl over Bo Jackson, in the Cotton Bowl over Tim Brown in Notre Dame, over Andre Ware in Houston 2 years ago, and last year in the Holiday Bowl over Ty Detmer and BYU. James Jacquette battles for a couple. Sophomore from St. Martinsville, Louisiana. Former Louisiana Offensive Player of the Year as a senior in high school. And we thought we'd be close to a sold-out house, and we are. About 4,000 under capacity at Kyle Field.
Well, I don't know where those empty seats are. I've seen them swaying out there, just going back and forth, and looks as if every seat is filled. Just a beautiful crowd on a beautiful day.
Marquette got 2, 2nd and 8. Blitz coming. Tigers pick it up. Loop way over Carl Hankton. And it'll be 3rd and 8. Something else that comes into play here for LSU, a team that's used to playing night games on grass. They're playing at 85 degree heat on AstroTurf in the afternoon.
Now, a lot of people wonder how much heat that turf gives off. You can always count an extra 10 to 15 degrees on the surface because the grass actually reflects the sun and builds up heat. I can tell you, the hottest thing out there are your feet when you play.
Two wideouts right, Hankton left, 1 3rd down. Loop on the roll, delivers, caught. Marcus Carter will be denied 1st down yardage. Marlon Haynes came over from strong safety along with Jason Atkinson. LSU's got to go for it.
I believe they do, too. Interesting play there. When you're a defensive corner, you're out there by yourself. You tackle high. You try to hold on. You don't go low trying to make that cut block. You hold on high and wait for your help to get there, and help was on the way.
If you're ever going to go for it, you're at the right spot on the field, and you're down 31 points with 17 minutes of football to play. Why wouldn't you go for it here?
Well, I think you're too concerned that the other team's going to drive the ball down your throat, but I agree with you, Dave. I think they should go for it. They may try to draw them off sides or something or have a trick play, but A&M won't fall for that.
Well, Griffith nails a beauty. Way over Derek Frazier back there instead of Biggins this time. and all they gain is 28 yards.
That's exactly what the gain is. When you bring it out to the 20-yard line, you've got basically a 28-yard punt. And he didn't even kick it for the corner. He kicked it right down the middle long.
Well, a little hard to figure. Hudson Curley Holman, 44 years of age, 1970 graduate of Texas A&M. And made the all-decade team of the 60s here at A&M. They're at halftime in Boulder. What we expected to see, a defensive battle. Rice trying for their first road non-conference win since the early 60s. 6-2 at Norman, North Texas and Oklahoma. Here we have 2:07 to go in the third. And Granger remains the quarterback. Hill remains the tailback. Bites off another big chunk, 19 more yards. And another touchdown, saving tackle by Anthony Marshall.
He doesn't even have to slow down. When he gets the ball deep in the backfield, watch this. Quarterback runs down, hands it to him deep. Look at this. Doesn't even have to slow down. Just avoids one. Knows exactly what he wants to do. Gets upfield. He's closing in on your 200. You may have a good point there. We're going to have to check the record books for that. I don't remember any running back starting off with 200 yards his first day.
Or even 180. Just amazing. Well, again, at the conclusion of today's game, Dave and I will announce the Southwest Airlines player of the game. I wonder who that was.
Well, now, I want to give fairness to this defensive unit of Texas A&M. Well, they played great football. Secondary, the linebackers, we talked about what great units they are. I think the defensive line has played extremely well. So I know with 180 yards his first day.
With all due respect.
I'm a defensive player, you see.
It's not going to be a defensive player.
But if you really want to know, stay tuned and we'll tell you.
Inside a minute, third quarter. Granger in trouble. Great athlete. He'll keep it. He needs midfield for the first down. He knew exactly where to put the foot out of bounds.
Well, out of bounds by number 54. Well, that's presence. When you're coming out there, you look at that flag, you know exactly how far you've got to get. You don't come up short. You run right at that flag. Here you'll see him rolling out again. Once he puts the ball away right here, this is run all the way. And look at him. You're going to see him look right down at that little flag. Right there, I got to get. First down.
Some freshmen are never really freshmen.
He's not. He hasn't made any mistakes today. Start off with what, a 40-yard pass, his first play?
He still got it on the bootleg. And Reggie Walker chases him out after a gain of a couple. Aggie fans think perhaps a late hit. Not so. I don't think that's what Granger had in mind there. Everybody went one way, he was left blind on the other side.
And I looked down there and Greg Hill turned around and put his arms out like, Coach, I went the right way, and he didn't give me the ball.
That's a tough sell, isn't it? I was right, 10 other guys were wrong. Granger could have been in somebody's minor league organization today. And if he were there, he'd be touted as a surefire major leaguer. Not many left-handers with his fastball and his slider. Tight end makes the catch. Second effort for the first down. That's James McKeon, the third team tight end brought down by Marshall.
Now, you talked about Granger being a freshman. I want to tell you, that was not a freshman throw. He got stuck in the chest. He saw it all the way in his face. Watch the quarterback here. He sees that ball. He sees them coming right down his throat, and he just held it to the last second before he picked up the tight end.
That's the first reception by an Aggie tight end today. Greg Shorp and Steve Sagraves are the first two on their depth chart, but it's McKeon making the grab. First and 10, Tiger 38. On what might be the final play of the third quarter. Greg Hill, more big yardage inside the 30. First down at the 26.
Tackle by number 18, Corey Reed.
I'll tell you, if I'm R.C. Slocum, I'm going to give my offensive line, I'm going to say, listen, don't even practice tomorrow. Just take the day off. I want you just to relax. Enjoy yourselves and don't do anything different.
Look at how he's dangling that left shoulder. Yep. That is not a good sign.
Yeah, when you run off like that, you've jammed the shoulder.
That's the end of the third quarter. We'll await word from the Aggie sideline on Greg Hill. And at the end of three, 38-7 A&M.
How to improve your home involves some difficult decisions.
You know, we could use a bigger kitchen.
A new bath.
Kitchen.
A new bath.
We could use a...
At NCNB, we don't think financing should be one of them.
Okay, a bath. Upstairs.
Upstairs.
That's why we've set up a loan information line. Call with your questions or stop by and see a loan specialist. Then tell us what's on your mind.
Okay, I got it. A garage.
A deck.
A garage.
1-800-ASK-NCNB.
Sweetheart.
The loan source.
Yes?
I want a deck.
You are what you eat. And what's true for you is true for your car. The right diet can make a difference. Fill up your car with Mobil Super Unleaded Plus. It has a detergent formula that's so advanced, it can actually unclog vital engine parts. For power and performance, get Mobil Super Unleaded Plus and drive your engine clean.
Come to the Isuzu Invitational and you might discover that you're a real trooper. Because you'll like the four-wheel drive with auto-locking hubs, tough four-wheel disc brakes, and knowing you got the best buy in town. Best of all, you'll love saving up to $2,300 more. So hurry, the Isuzu Invitational is the perfect time to be a trooper and to compare and save, or really just save, because with Isuzu, there's no comparison. Save on Trooper at your local Houston area Isuzu dealer.
LSU fans waving the white flag, down 31 points. They got to tip their hat to the Aggies through three quarters. A&M up 35-0 at halftime. Total yardage now near 500 yards. But the big question is, how is Greg Hill? Came off holding that left shoulder very gingerly. Rodney Thomas checks in at tailback. First down and 10. Here's Thomas. Look at him carry Wayne Williams about 8 yards. Looked like a good open field hit by Williams. 8 yards later, Thomas is finally brought down.
Well, what happened is Williams, when he came up, he broke down, but he had nothing behind him. And he just got carried back by Thomas. There's Greg Hill.
I don't know that we'll see him again today.
No, you don't bring him back in this situation. A lot of people would say, hey, he's got 194 yards unofficially. Would you bring him back in to get 200? No way. You don't bring him back in.
But it's a good sign. They don't have his shoulder pads off. They don't have ice on him. Might have just been something popping out of joint. Maybe it's back in joint now. Second effort. Gross to the 15.
Well, if he gets back in this football game, he's going to have to do a lot of talking there to R.C. Slocum on the sideline saying, hey, coach, I'm fine, I'm fine. But I just don't think you bring him back in this situation.
No question, especially when you look at the number of limp-offs the A&M side has seen today. That's the only negative. They have seen Richardson limp off with a bad foot in the first quarter, Doug Carter with a bad ankle, Randy Simmons with an ankle, and now Greg Hill. That's four backfield contributors. Granger straight ahead. Powers inside the 10, first and goal.
Wait a minute now. Powers? Powers, you're right. He got hit right on the line of scrimmage. That's just sloppy tackling. You can't let a quarterback do this. Watch this. He gets hit right there. Boom. Now he gets right there. Gets hit again. Then picks up 7-8 yards. That's just sloppy tackling.
Ivory Hilliard and Wayne Williams finally dragged it down. First and goal.
I bet that's the first time he's ever been described as powers. Quarterbacks don't think of powering.
Thomas. 5-yard line, cuts it up, leaps, touchdown. The first, but definitely not the last, career touchdown for Rodney Thomas. Seven carries, 76 yards in his collegiate debut. He's lost in the Greg Hill time glory, but what a day he's had. And Venatulius on for yet another extra point. 45-7.
You know, Granger made a great adjustment on that play. He really was behind the play, was able to reach out. Watch Granger's play. He's really behind here. Reaches out right there. Reaches out and makes the play. He's a little bit behind the play and has to make that adjustment. But you're right. Watch Thomas. Over the top.
Any other day, it would be the Rodney Thomas story. We'll return after this from Southwest Airlines.
Ever since Southwest Airlines introduced our Friends Fly Free sale, people have gotten friendlier.
Sugar Plum, your favorite pillow.
If you make reservations and buy your round-trip ticket at our regular low unrestricted fare by October 31st, a friend gets to fly with you this fall, free.
Hey, Dad, seen the hedge trimmer?
You and a friend can travel through January 6th.
Here's that putter I borrowed last year, old buddy.
Southwest Airlines Friends Fly Free sale. It's great for your pocketbook and your popularity.
There is a new gasoline that is clearly advanced. A new gasoline that will give you the highest level of engine cleaning for high performance. A new gasoline formulated to clean fuel injectors and intake valves. Who has this new gasoline? You know who. New Phase 4 gasoline from Exxon for cleaner engines and high performance.
The Schick Tracer storyline so far in today's game. LSU has got nothing through the air, even less on the ground. A&M near 400 yards on the ground, but Simmons, Hill, Richardson, and Carter have all left at one time or another with injuries. ...13-10 still to play, and it's 45-7 Texas A&M. 8 yards deep, Vincent Fuller for the touchback. And we just got some really surprising news from the A&M bench.
That Greg Hill will be back? That's a shock to me. Now, if he's not injured, he sure can. Well, look at him there. He looks awful nice. You were right. They didn't put any ice on his shoulder. They didn't even take his shoulder pads off.
Here's your story all afternoon. A&M yards on first down. Almost gets him another first down. LSU about half that. Chad Luke, the quarterback, sacked at the 13. The Aggies do it by committee. Lance Tackleman, the first Aggie back there from left defensive end.
This is just a swarm. Everybody just coming inside. Nice move there by 58 Tackleman. That's a swim move inside. What you do is you actually, like Toreador, you come on him, and what you do is you actually swim over. You bring that left arm over top and swim inside. That's a pro move.
Miami did that all day, all night to Houston. Loss of five, second and 15. Atkinson coming on the blitz. Luke loops it over to Jacquette, who was ridden out of bounds at the 19. Haven't called Kevin Smith's name much today. He needs one interception to become the all-time Southwest Conference career interception leader. They have thrown away from him today, and that's probably going to be his story all year long.
Well, what a marvelous corner. Reading some of the things that he says in the papers leads me to believe that he really knows how to play the game of corner. He said he entices the quarterback to try to bring him into his area to throw. He makes the receiver think that he's open. He's got great closing speed. He says, I try to guess what their pattern's going to be. I study film. He does all the things that a great cornerback does.
Way over Kinchin. Smith and Marlon Haynes, the nearest defenders. Kevin Smith says about 70% of the time, I think I can predict what pattern the wideout's going to run against me.
Well, what he does is he looks at the way the wideout lines up on him. He looks at his hips when he comes off the line. He sees if he's cheating inside. He knows that he's going to run an out pattern. He studies his eyes when he breaks out of the huddle. He does, like I said, he does all the things that you think a great cornerback would do.
Wilbert Biggins back in after being replaced earlier by Derek Frazier. Handles this one cleanly and then reverses field. Big hit by Rodney Young. Timeout, 12-10 to play. A&M leads by 38.
They're right. New Diet Dr. Pepper does taste more like regular Dr. Pepper.
So let's have another.
New Diet Dr. Pepper. There's no...
5, 6, 7, and... Come on, you can do it! 6, 7, Again! 6, 7, 8.
After making it on Broadway, some of the finest entertainers around go off-Broadway. They appear on Norwegian Cruise Line. No other cruise line offers such entertainment. Norwegian Cruise Line, the best vacation you've ever had. Plus.
Most of my friends don't know what they're going to do after graduation, but I've already locked in guaranteed skill training in the Army. Qualify now and you can reserve even the Army's most sought-after technical training up to 12 months in advance through the Army's Delayed Entry Program. Sure, being a soldier won't be easy, but then nothing worth having ever is.
Hello?
This is Thelma downstairs. What was that?
Diet Dr. Pepper. It tastes more like regular Dr. Pepper.
Can I try one?
I'll send George right down.
Aggie football obviously in good hands today. The new man in charge of Aggie basketball joins us now, Tony Barone, making the transition from head coaching at Creighton to Texas A&M. What do you think of A&M atmosphere? I'm sure you heard a lot about it before you took the job. Now you're seeing it firsthand.
Dave, you can't understand it until you're here. I went to the Yell practice last night and was mesmerized for an hour. It's incredible. We need to capture a little bit of it for basketball.
How do you do that? What's step one?
We beg for some support. We need to prove we're going to have a good program, Dave, and we're going to. I'm excited about it.
Stick around. I got a couple more questions for you. 12-10 to play in the game. A&M from the 43-yard line. Granger remains the quarterback. And Greg Hill is back in at tailback, and that should put him over 200 yards. A new A&M freshman single-game rushing record.
Well, I would hope that's his last play. You can see the crowd, they think it is too. I just, again, I understand trying to get him over 200 yards, and that's certainly a milestone, but I just don't think you take a chance.
Only the 10th Aggie running back ever to gain 200 yards, and he does it first time out of the gate.
What does he do next week?
That's a good question. He got 9. Rodney Thomas slams to the 42. He's got the first down. Tony Barone, you've got a lot of holes to fill on your roster. Do you go immediately to the junior college ranks? How do you start to fill in your talent?
Dave, we can't do it that way. We need to really start off bringing in some quality young people and build for the consistency of the program over an extended period of time. I have a lifelong contract here, so I'm not worried about that.
We've also got a new arena, which I guess 3 years down the road will be online, 14,000 seats. That's got to help.
2 years, Dave. It will be finished. Yes, sir. 1, 18.
Granger underthrows. The intended receiver, Gross, second and 10. Can you get Granger, you think, to be a three-sport man?
Well, I understand that he's a heck of a quarter-miler also.
Four-sport man.
Yeah, we'd love to have him. I'd like a couple of these linemen to come in and take over the middle like Dave over here. We'd like to get him down on the court also.
Do you have a goal in terms of time? At what point do you figure you'll have all the pieces in place here?
I don't know, Dave. It's just going to take us some time. We're just going to do it slowly and do it over an extended period of time.
Coach, can you ask me, what's a lifelong contract? I'm sitting over here thinking, what's a lifelong contract? How long are you going to live?
I was waiting for someone to comment. I hope John David Crow heard that comment. I think what we're trying to do here is going to take some time, and the administration is really open to building the program over a consistency factor, and I think that's the right way to do it.
But let me ask you about the lifelong contract. That's something I heard. The first time I heard it was with Spike Dykes out at Texas Tech. Does it give you the ability not to have to cut the corners and take the easy way out?
I think you have to just do things the right way, Dave. And if you're comfortable with that, that's the way to do it.
Ranger may be changing the play again. First time he did that, he went for 41 yards. This time on the slant in, the completion to the 37-yard line for Chris Sanders. Aggies have a lot of openings at wide receiver. Sanders with his first catch of the day.
Well, this is just a slant in. It's a quick audible. Anytime you slant in, that receiver's got his chest to the quarterback, and it's just a big target. If you've got a quarterback that can drill the ball in there, we know Granger throws a 94-mile-an-hour fastball. He threw another strike. 5 of 8, 89 yards. Not bad for the third-team quarterback listed to start the game.
Third down and 4 for Granger. And again, audibilizes. He has not been shy about changing the play, and he calls time here. Ball was snapped, but they will rule the timeout was called before the snap. And that stops the clock at 10 minutes and 14 seconds to go. We'll take it with him. 45-7 A&M here at College Station.
How to improve your home involves some difficult decisions.
You know, we could use a bigger kitchen.
Nuh-uh, a new bath.
Uh-uh, kitchen.
A new bath.
We could use a...
At NCNB, we don't think financing should be one of them.
Okay, a bath. Upstairs.
Upstairs.
That's why we've set up a loan information line. Call with your questions or stop by and see a loan specialist. Then tell us what's on your mind.
Okay, I got it. A garage.
Uh-uh, a deck.
A garage.
1-800-ASK-NCNB.
Sweetheart.
The loan source.
Yes?
I want a deck.
If your face were square, shaving would be simple. If your face were flat, any razor would do. But your face has curves. You need the revolutionary Schick Tracer, the first razor with a blade that flexes to trace every curve on your face. Compared to other razors, Tracer puts more of the blade edge against your skin. For real faces, just like yours. Tracer from Schick traces every curve on your face.
Turn on Raycom and turn on excitement. For the best in sports, turn on Raycom.
It'll be 3rd and 4 after the A&M timeout. Tony Barone, A&M basketball coach with us. When do you get underway? What day is the first day of practice?
We start October 15th, Dave. That's our official starting date. We're in some preseason conditioning now, but that's when we can actually go out on the court.
Do you do the 12:01 a.m. first practice deal?
No, I never liked that. I thought it took too much out of the kids for a couple of days.
Granger long count, 3rd and 4. Bobble, Thomas lost it. Still loose, and the Aggies hang on, but they lose one. And it'll be 4th and 4. Recovery by Jeff Jones, the backup left tackle. What's your philosophy as we look at the replay of the recovery by Jones?
He just never got the handle in the ball, and it just popped out. Jones right there to recover.
Tony, your philosophy on involving the players with all the on-campus activities here at A&M.
Dave, you know, we have a tremendous university, and I think it would be a crime if we didn't get our basketball players and all the athletes involved in as many on-campus activities as we possibly can. We want the kids to be a part of the student body and not apart from it. I think it's really key to our success to get the kids involved on campus.
Well, we look forward to watching them.
Thank you, Dave. I appreciate it. We're looking forward to the season.
Tony Barone, new Aggie head basketball coach, up here with us. And another mark off, delay of game with 9:23 to play.
Dave, I was going to see if he could do color on one just to prove that he couldn't do color. He's a it's a great basketball coach, but hey, wait a minute now, coach.
You can't see the numbers up there. How can you do color when you can't see the numbers?
That's my secret. I'm not telling.
That's what these other 19 guys are doing up here.
David Davis will kick it from his 43 to Todd Kinchin at his 12. Heavy rush, but a nice job by Davis and a nose-up spiral. And an Aggie bounce killed at the 1-foot line by Larry Jackson.